Proof of prior year payment required when filing. New clients only at participating locations through April 7th. Terms at jacksonhewitt.com.
With crippling inflation, the locally owned Mine Chef restaurant in Hartford has the best Tuesday dining value anywhere. WTMJ's John Mercier here. The all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet is just $9.99. It's all your favorite authentic Mexican food for $9.99. Kids and grandkids, 5 and under, eat free from the kids' menu. Sunday through Thursday, they can safely play in that huge game room while you finish up your all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet. The Mine Shaft is super affordable and very family-friendly. The Wednesday and Friday fish fry is now just $4.99. That's a crazy low price, $4.99. Stop today for the Tuesday all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet for $9.99. Desserts are always buy one, get one free. Come early today. From 2 till 5, cocktails, beers, and appetizers are half price. The Mine Shaft in beautiful downtown Hartford and in Oshkosh. It's big food. It's big fun. It's the Mine Shaft. No reservations needed. Just walk on in. MineChefRestaurant.com. Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call. That's All Sports Desk. It's finally opening day for the Brewers here at home. Parking opens at 12:10 and the gates open at 1:10. We're live from American Family Field until our Brewers Radio Network coverage starts at 2:35. Bob Uecker will be on the mic for today's home opening game. Check those roads. Debbie Lazaga, been a sloppy, messy morning.
It has been. Very wet, very cold, and icky bad. We've got 894 eastbound with an accident at 60th Street. Got the two left lanes blocked. As you might imagine, we got big delays all the way back through the Hale interchange. Westbound on 894, heading through that construction zone, is still going to be slow anyway. So wet roads, and we've got those lanes out because they're working on the medians in that area. So that's also backing things up. As far as around the stadium is concerned, we are still in good shape. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Traffic is sponsored by TabakAttorneys.com. Hurt at work? Call Tabak for the payback. An injury at work may leave you eligible for compensation benefits, including lost wages, coverage of medical bills, or a cash settlement. Call Tabak for the payback. TabakAttorneys.com.
Time for your Storm Team 4 5-day forecast. A Fleet Farm Storm Team alert. A winter storm warning issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. Today, windy with rain. Eventually, it all changes to snow for most of southeast Wisconsin. High of 39 degrees today. Tomorrow, breezy with snow likely to continue accumulations north and west of the city. Wednesday, snowy and windy. When it's all said and done Wednesday, 6 inches of snow in metro Milwaukee and north, less to the south. On Thursday, rain, a high of 41. Friday, sunny, 43. On Saturday, mostly sunny, a high of 46 degrees. In Madison right now, rainy and 37 degrees. In Green Bay, rainy and 37. In Waukesha, little rain-snow mix, it's 37 degrees. I'm John Mercier, Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 1110.
From American Family Field, it's Brewers Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Now, here are your hosts, Jessica Tye and Greg Matzig.
Well, here we go. The roof is closed for those keeping score at home. Players are out in the outfield. The Brewers getting their early warm-up in. The batting cage is set up. We got Willy Adames in the cage taking some swings, and he just put one off the wall for those keeping score at home. Yes, it is opening day for the Milwaukee Brewers, Jessica, and we are inside the friendly confines here of American Family Field. Thankfully, because outside it's not so great, but inside going to be a great day.
The rain is pouring down. There are puddles outside. It is windy, too, but the roof, oh, how we love the roof at American Family Field. Roof for the win today, and hopefully the Brewers later, too.
Yeah, so the Twins are in town. The Brewers coming back from New York with 3 straight wins. Very impressive beginning to the season. We'd love to see that. So off to a good start here as the Pat Murphy era is underway. It is the big story we are covering on a wet and soggy Tuesday.
And now it's time for a Brewers special edition of Three Big Things on Wisconsin's Midday News.
Number one, after 3 consecutive wins in New York to start the season, the Brewers are back in Milwaukee. The Brew Crew takes down the Minnesota Twins for today's home opener. First pitch is at 3:10 this afternoon. Parking lots officially open, in about an hour here at 12:10. Regardless of whether you purchase parking in advance or plan to purchase today, you will need to scan the QR code upon arrival to activate your parking. That is key, and that is new this year. Very important to remember. The Brewers do have parking ambassadors on site to help you with that process. I'm sure a couple people have questions. You always do when it's new, right? But it's designed to be easy. Gates to enter the stadium open at 1:10 today.
That is it. So, yeah, that's going to be here before too long. And if you're working your way down, yes, remember what Jessica just said about parking. It's a little different. There are QR codes. You're not going to be handing an attendant money this time. And just make sure you follow the process. And it's going to be a very easy process, I think, if you just follow the logical steps here. New season, Jessica, also means new food offerings at the ballpark. We always love this. And the Brewers have partnered with the 3rd Street Market Hall, where our studios are located, to bring the best of the Market Hall to American Family Field. So Venezuelan arepas, tacos, sushi, barbecue, and it's a cool 3rd Street Market Hall designed section called the Annex. Omar Sheikh is the owner and operator of 3rd Street Market Hall. He was a guest on Wisconsin's Midday News last week.
We just wanted to do different types of offerings, right? And so a little more ethnic and authentic offerings. And it's going to be an area to gather where families can come together. And so the area also has a turfed area. It also has video games, also has games you can play it. There's a sight line of TVs all throughout the area. And so it's just like, look, you want to sit in 9 innings all in one seat, that's great. But if you want to go out and meet people in a gathering, have your kids, have activities to do with, you get authentic food, hey, 3rd Street Market Hall at Annex is the place to go in AmFam.
Yeah, love that. So you got some great offerings. And the Brewers have done a great job with this. They have found a way to bring your favorite restaurant in the Milwaukee area
right
inside the park here, which I think is great.
It's a miniature version of 3rd Street Market Hall. In fact, where we are right now, we're taking a look at it. They've got that awesome sign that looks exactly like the one downtown. And when you were telling all the food items, the new ones, yum, I just got excited. I
mean, right?
If you want to come to the ballpark and just have a hot dog and some popcorn and a soda, that's fine. We've got that here. But we also have all this other stuff, too. I mean, ramen at the ballpark. Today is a good day for ramen.
You're not right.
Warm comfort. You up after walking from outside inside. Also, here's what else you need to know today. Hall of Fame announcer Bob Uecker will be on the mic for the first pitch of 2024. At 90 years old, how incredible is that? He enters his 54th season as a broadcaster for his home team, calling games right here on 620 WTMJ. Also, three special Brewers super fans are in charge of the ceremonial first pitch. These are the boys who got a surprise trip to Phoenix for a VIP weekend at Brewers spring training. You might remember the stories about this. One has battled a cancerous brain tumor, another has a congenital heart defect, and the other Crohn's disease. They are all receiving treatment through Aurora Healthcare, a partner of the Milwaukee Brewers. So those boys and you, Greg, they will all be getting a big applause today.
Absolutely. Looking forward to that. Bob Uecker behind the mic for the first pitch of today's game against the Twins. In the dugout right now, I can see him. He's got a headset on. We're going to be joined by Brewers outfielder Blake Perkins coming up on the other side. It's 11:15 on WTMJ.
Throughout history, some people have been born into greatness because of their name or family. Others gained greatness because of their actions. On Wisconsin's Morning News, we celebrate everyday heroes, the John or Jane Doe who had no idea when they woke up one morning they'd be saving a life. Everyday Heroes, Thursday at 6:40 on Wisconsin's Morning News, presented by Azura Memory Care and Assisted Living, transforming the culture of care.
Since 1955, Geist Garage Doors has been the trusted authority in Wisconsin. You know the name, right? Well, don't let a busted garage door get you down. All you have to do is call the folks at Geist. They have got a design item for you. Custom design. They can do it. In fact, I've seen them sanding down a wood door, getting it ready for stain at their showroom in Brookfield. It's right off Barker Road. I have also seen the hundreds of doors and openers they have on display and in stock. That can mean a very quick turnaround time for you. For swift and reliable garage repair solutions, it is Geist. Visit geistdoors.com or give them a call, 262-784-4250, or do what I did. Check out their showroom in Brookfield. See what they have on display and what could be installed at your house. When you need them, they are there for you. It's Geist, trusted in the state of Wisconsin. From Cudahy to Cedarburg and all points in between, don't think twice. Call Geist.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender, NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Well, things are wet out there for sure, and we do have a couple of issues actually on 894 eastbound, right about at 57th Street. Two left lanes are blocked with a crash. Now, that's affecting your ride pretty heavily coming out of the Hale interchange. Give yourself tons of time. We've also got westbound 894 backing up from 27th Street all the way through the construction zone to 60th Street. Right near the stadium, though, so far, so good. Everything is rolling along pretty well. Not seeing too many issues, and some of those parking lots are going to start to fill up. We'll try and give you the updates as they come in. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Brewers Opening Day Live presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Greg Matzik and Jessica Tai overlooking the field. Batting practice is underway. Willie is still in the batting cage. He has not left the batting cage. He's getting that early time in, and he's got his little swagger on. Sleeveless hoodie. He's got the yellow shoes on. All set for opening day. It's about style on opening day, too.
Hey, and you know what else we saw that was pretty cool, just to give people kind of a sneak peek into the world that we're seeing right now? We saw the Brewers setting up, kind of testing out some pyrotechnics today.
Right, and that is not far away from our guest, Blake Perkins, Brewers outfielder. Blake, by your estimation, are you going to get lit on fire when you run out of the dugout today? Man, I certainly hope Blake does not catch on fire when he runs out of the dugout today. So we are efforting him. We'll have him turn his headset up a little bit there, too.
It was pretty wild to see, though. I mean, they've got, 2, 4, they've got 6 little areas where all of a sudden I just saw sparks flying up. It reminded me of some people when they get married. That's one of the newer things to have, is kind of those pyrotechnics as you do your first dance.
Sure.
But this is going to be, I mean, they're still working it out there. They're making sure that it's perfect and everything is good to go there for the pyrotechnics as the Brewers run out of the dugout.
All right, let's check in with Blake Perkins. Blake, can you hear us okay?
Yeah, I can hear you guys. Thank you. Can you hear me?
Hey, man. Yeah, man, we're a little nervous that you might be set on fire running out of the dugout today for warm-ups. We saw the little pyrotechnic display they got set up there.
Yeah, I'm excited to see what they got planned for us. I hope not I don't get set on fire, but I'm excited.
Right.
For sure.
You know, I go back to last year, Blake. You know, you were part of this organization through spring training, but you didn't get to experience opening day here at American Family Field. What's this day like for you, right? This is kind of a first-time opportunity for you.
Yeah, I'm just extremely grateful and, like I said, just very excited to be here and be a part of it and just to take it all in and support my teammates and get a win. Come on.
Yeah, come on. Let's go, right? Hey, we're now just hours away from the first pitch of the Brewers home opener here at American Family Field. How are you feeling about the team in general? After going through spring training, after being here this morning, you're about to open it all up for all of the hometown fans. How are you feeling about this season ahead?
I will say excited again. Just being with the guys in spring and this first weekend, it just shows the competitive spirit we got as a group, and I feel like we're all meshing together really well so far, and I think that'll only build as the season goes along, and I hope the fans and the people here at AmFam get to experience that with us.
You know, Blake, as a part of this team last year, you got to experience what a Craig Council managed team looks like. Of course, Pat Murphy was right there alongside Craig. Any differences? Is there a noticeable difference in how the Pat Murphy-led Brewers are versus what you experienced last season?
Well, first off, I enjoyed playing for Council a lot. It was a great time last year, and it was nice the transition having Pat be the manager this year. Already kind of having a relationship with him, and you know, so far it's been for sure, I mean, different. They're different people, but I think as the season goes along, we'll see the intricate differences between the both of them. But I think the reason they were together so long and did so well is because they think similarly. So I won't be surprised if we see some of the same kind of tactics this year.
Blake, we have a lot of good food here in Milwaukee. We were just talking about some of the new stuff at 3rd Street Market Hall here inside the ballpark. But does anything come close to your mom's home cooking, which you were so lucky to enjoy during spring training since Arizona's home for you?
I think not. I don't want to say there's anything better than that because she might get mad. But seriously, yes. Her cooking will always be the best in my eyes. And it's always good being able to see my family during spring training and have them out there supporting me. And, you know, it just feels like home, which is really nice.
I was going to say, did you get a chance to sleep in your own bed a little bit during spring training, or did you have separate accommodations?
This year, I didn't stay there. I might have maybe once or twice during the off season, early in the off season, but no, I didn't live there this year.
I read you consider yourself a partial musician because you can somewhat play several instruments. What are those instruments, and did you decide you just couldn't go all in on one?
Well, I grew up, my dad played guitar, so I was introduced to guitar when I was really young, and that's something that I'll always try and stay on top of. But I just think during the season, it's hard for me to make time for it. But guitar, I know how to play bass and a little bit of piano here and there.
Blake Perkins joining us here at American Family Field, our opening day coverage presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. You know, you bring up an interesting point, Blake. You get into the rigors of a season, it's hard to find downtime. It's hard to take advantage of those off days. How did you manage that last year in what was, you know, for the most part, a full season in the big leagues? How challenging is that?
It is a challenge in itself, for sure. Just being able to manage your time correctly. I just lean on my teammates who have been around a lot longer than I have and ask them for advice when I can. But for the most part, these off days, I just try and relax and rest my body, maybe do a little bit of moving around. But I'll be honest, I can be pretty boring on the days off.
Boring by design. There's nothing wrong with that, Blake.
Okay.
I think your coaching staff would appreciate that.
Yeah, for sure.
I was checking out the Brewers' social media feed, and I can tell during your off days, you're not practicing drawing the state of Wisconsin.
No, I'm not. I know. That needs to get better, and I will do better if that ever comes back up.
So I got to paint the picture for all the listeners here and all the fans. The Brewers asked Blake and a number of the other teammates to draw the state of Wisconsin. And, Blake, I swear yours looks more like a mitten than the state of Wisconsin.
I know. It does. I rounded it out a little bit too much there. I thought I had the general idea down, but I needed to, you know, no state is completely round, so that's on the
of a point where the thumb goes. It's not that rounded thing that goes into the you'll work on it. Well, Blake, we're looking forward to today, man. Congratulations too on breaking camp with the Brewers and being here for your first opening day experience at American Family Field, man. I know it's a really exciting day for you.
Yes, sir. It will be exciting, and I thank you guys for having me, and go Brewers.
You bet. Thank you so much. Brewers outfielder Blake Perkins joining us here as some early batting practice going on. Willy Adames is back in the cage. A big surprise. Some guys do this. Christian Yelich likes to be out as part of early groups as well. And right now he's got a handful of players out in the outfield getting some long tossing in. Littered with baseballs is the portion right behind the dirt here as the infield transitions to outfield, all the balls being thrown back in.
Oh, one looks
and
like...
somebody might have to fish. Oh, bounce back.
I thought it was going out.
It did go out. It bounced back. It was up in the stand so high. And the new scoreboards, by the way, if you've not been inside the field to see this or seen pictures of it, my goodness, you will be amazed at how big and vibrant the new scoreboard is. Pretty amazing stuff here. Plenty more to get to here, including more conversations with players, the best of Bob Uecker, and more as we work our way to 1 o'clock and ultimately first pitch here at American Family Field, scheduled for 3:10. It's 11:26 on WTMJ.
Brewers Opening Day Live continues after this. Cheese doodles, Mr. Nougat bar. Oh, here we go. Four-door hatchback.
Some things are fine to buy from a vending machine, but a car's not one of them. That national online company makes it seem convenient, but it won't be so convenient if you have a problem with the vehicle you buy. And if it's after 7 days, good luck. Adam member dealers also let you search online, plus test drive the vehicle before you buy it. And they're right here to handle any issues.
What? The car's stuck. No!
Start your search at ADAMM.com.
When families seriously injured in accidents and standing up for victims to take the burden off your shoulders. It's Gruber Law Offices, and it's all about family at Gruber Law Offices. David and his team of lawyers represent you in the best way possible if you've been hurt or injured in an accident. And they focus on the legal aspect while you focus on the healing. That really is peace of mind. And it really is just one call, and that's all. They will handle the rest. One of the largest personal injury firms in the Midwest, they get results, and it speaks for themselves. Gruber Law has been doing it in Wisconsin for over 35 years. Check out their website. It's gruber-law.com. If you need their services, they are there for you. Locally known, nationally recognized, gruber-law.com. In addition, see all the ways that David and his team give back to the community. Can't walk around the stadium we're at right now without feeling the presence of Gruber Law. They give back. 276-6666, should you need to reach them, 414-276-6666 for Gruber Law Offices.
It's WTMJ's Debbie Lozaga for Comfort Awnings. You've heard me talk about the wonderful new retractable awning the team at Comfort Awnings installed at my home. Now I can have all the cookouts and get-togethers in my backyard with some extra shade and relaxation for my guests. Comfort Awnings is a local family-owned company in Burlington that provides expert installation in southeast Wisconsin and northern Illinois. Right now, you'll receive $250 off with the purchase of any awning or screen until April 14th. Call 414-AWNINGS or visit comfortawnings.com.
Here's to sweet summer days together with friends and family in Wisconsin. To discovering magic in every moment.
Come on, over here.
And to reconnecting through a world filled with wonder.
Wow.
Here's to supper club celebrations and dancing until the sun goes down. Here's to those who Wisconsin. Plan your summer getaway at travelwisconsin.com.
The sooner you address your joint pain, the better. You really don't want your pain to become chronic, to a point when surgery may become your only option. Address your joint pain issues early and calm down that inflammation and increase your mobility. Get the joints moving again and the blood circulating. That can be very beneficial. Plus, why not just feel better sooner? By coming to Rejuvenix, at the very least, we can alleviate your pain so you can feel and move better to help you live a better quality of life. Don't you deserve at least that? Multi-joint treatments at Rejuvenix can cost as little as, well, nothing. That's because we are in-network with almost all major insurance plans, including Medicare and Medicaid. So you really have nothing to lose, except a very good chance of living with a lot less pain. This is Richard Salinas, registered nurse with Rejuvenix Arthritis Clinics, where we can alleviate your pain and rejuvenate your life. Go to Rejuvenix.com to request your appointment.
Hey, WTMJ's John Merck here. I've got a great trip coming up this Christmas. I want you to be with us. It's Magical Christmas Markets. 5 nights in Innsbruck, the capital of the Alps. We'll take in a horse-drawn carriage ride, make traditional strudel, and spend lots of time shopping in beautiful, historic Christmas markets throughout Europe. It is going to be special hunting for those treasures. I've got a beautiful brochure. I'll send it to you. Shoot me an email, john.mercure@wtmj.com. John.mercure, M-E-R-C-U-R-E at WTMJ.com. Magical Christmas Markets this December. Won't you come with us?
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Siding and Limited WTMJ News Time 11:31. I'm John Mercure. Today's opening day. It's also election day. Voters will make choices in everything from the presidential primary to their local school board. There are also two constitutional amendments that deal with outside money and elections in the state. as well as nearly 100 tax increase questions, including an MPS referendum. Polls are open until 8 o'clock. In Kenosha, the Unified School District there has a school board election. 8 candidates vying for 4 spots. The 3 highest performing candidates will get 3-year terms. The candidate with the 4th most votes will serve a 2-year term. Kenosha Unified faces hard times as last year they voted to close schools, repurpose buildings, and cut staff. And the national political scene comes to Wisconsin today as well. Former President Donald Trump scheduled to make an appearance at the Hyatt Regency in Green Bay, although the weather's really bad there this afternoon. Meanwhile, the White House says President Biden will visit Madison on Monday, April 8th. Time for news about your money. The WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. It's all red today. The S&P 500 right now is off 51 points. The Dow is off 260. Make that 462. That's more than 1%. The NASDAQ is off 209 points. Annex Comprehensive Wealth. Annex Private Client. Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. Let's check those roads. Debbie Lozica has a look. Hello, Deb.
Hey there, John. Yeah, a little good news. We had that earlier accident on 894 at 60th Street. That has been cleared. Still have some residual delays, but that, a lot of that has to do with the construction going on through that area. So westbound's a little bit tight all the way to 68th. Southbound, 894 slowing from Howard Avenue and around the Hale. Now, around the stadium interchange, that's actually looking pretty good so far. Wet, of course, but no backups to speak of as of yet. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Weather, the big story today. A Fleet Farm storm team alert has been issued. A winter storm warning for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. Today, windy with rain for most of the day, changing to snow. Far north and west of the metro area could get 6 to 9 inches of snow. 3 inches or less in Milwaukee, a high of 39 degrees. The snow continues overnight. That's when the accumulation really ramps up, a low of 33 degrees. Snow winds down tomorrow, a high of 37. On Thursday, chance for rain and windy, a high of 41. Friday, sunny, 43. Saturday, mostly sunny, a high of 46 degrees. In Madison right now, it's snowy and 36 degrees. In Green Bay, snowy, rainy, 37 degrees. In Waukesha, mixed bag in 36 degrees. Right here in Milwaukee, it's 37. I'm John Mercier, Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 1134.
Brewers Opening Day Live presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Greg Matzik and Jessica Tai in the climate-controlled American Family Field. It is beautiful in here. The field looks perfect, doesn't it?
It does. We do such a good job. We,
you know. Yeah, right. You and I were out there on the Toros earlier today doing some fertilizing.
I'm kind of meaning we as in Milwaukee, but man, sure. Every year it is just absolutely incredible to see how green it is, how perfect it is. But I don't know, doesn't it seem even brighter this year? I think it has to do with these humongous screens.
You know, I posted a picture earlier today and tweeted it out, and I had somebody come back and say, hey, did they swap out the green seats at American Family Field? They look blue. And no, that was a reflection off the scoreboard. It is that big.
It is just massive. And then it's not just the main one, but then you've got the side one over to the right as well that I think has surprised a lot of people. They're like, oh, wasn't expecting that.
They have a scoreboard that I think rivals the size of the old scoreboard. And it's, I guess, to be considered the auxiliary scoreboard. It is in right field, you know, several decks up, right above the Pottawatomie Casino Hotel sign in the right field area. You cannot miss it. It is unbelievable. So, yes, very bright with all the lights here inside American Family Field. Outside in the parking lot, not quite as climate controlled. We've found a way for him to warm up. It's Eric Bilstadt. Hey, Eric.
Hello, hello. Happy opening day to you both.
Yes, you good, man? Everything all right out there?
No, it's awful. It is absolutely miserable. It's wet, it's rainy, it's ridiculously windy, so like my umbrella's all busted up, but I am the only one who's not really smiling. Everyone else out here seems to be enjoying themselves.
Well, that's the thing. We have diehard Brewers fans here in Wisconsin, and I saw a couple people in tents. What are you seeing? I know technically the parking lots are not open yet, but have you met some of the diehard fans out there? What are their stories?
Well, actually, Jessica, I can break some news for you. At least the lot here on the west side is open, so they are letting cars in now. But yes, there are some folks that have the tarps up. I caught up with a group earlier this morning as they were enjoying the festivities.
Okay, so where are you guys from?
From Milwaukee, right here, baby.
Milwaukee. All right, so what time you get here?
Oh, about 9:30.
9:30.
All right, so what's the biggest challenge of these conditions?
Nothing. Staying warm, but we got it. We got it.
All right, you guys got a tarp up and everything. Not bad.
Everyone else is in the vehicles. We figured we'd be out here and start a tailgate early.
Now, are you guys disappointed? You're not even close to being the first ones.
We're okay. We're close enough.
What are we cooking here?
We got cinnamon buns, and we got burgers. We got brats. We got a lot of other stuff later on.
We got some chocolate dip pretzels with the Brewers colors.
Is this a tradition or?
Every year.
Rain or shine.
Well, exactly rain today, but yes, and shine.
All right.
We've been here through the snow. We've been here through the wind. We had wood chips in our vehicle a few years back because it was so windy. It was taking the wood chips off the planters and loading them into vehicles. We're here.
Yeah.
So oh, man.
Those guys are enjoying themselves. Lots of people starting to feel it. And a couple of things to remember, too. You have that interesting parking situation now where you use a QR code. And also a reminder, guys, that there oftentimes can be lines getting into the stadium. So keep that in mind. If there's going to be lines, you might be standing in the rain. I mean, it is raining here. You want to enjoy some puddles? You can hear some puddles there. Yeah, I'm walking through puddles now. I will share this little nugget, though. I did talk to a Twins fan in his car who did offer to have me sit in his Volvo with him.
And oh,
I said, no,
nice.
I'm good. I'll figure it out. I don't need to sit in the vehicle with you. But just so you know, the Minnesota fans are awfully nice.
Yes, hospitable. Well, yes, it wouldn't be an opening day without some challenges out in the outside, but it sounds like it did not deter the tailgating at 9:30 this morning when the rain was coming down.
No, and it's raining right now, and everyone's loving it.
Eric, and you could really hear that wind in those interviews, too. And interesting to note, I appreciate the fact that you told us about the parking lot being open, because the parking lots, they always say they don't officially open until 3 hours before the game. So today officially opening at 12:10, you said they already opened. And in years past, it always seemed to be that they would do it just a little bit earlier than they said. But I wondered this year if they would or they wouldn't, because hopefully this new parking system speeds things up. But obviously people are going to have questions, so.
Very true. And I'm curious how that's all going to play out when it comes down to when people are going to try to get into the stadium as well, because you have a lot of people that are going to get wet and miserable. I mean, it is, trust me, I love you diehards. You guys are great. I love all you folks out here enjoying it, but it is absolutely miserable. Like, there's no one who's going to say that it's a nice day. I mean, we are getting poured on right now.
Yeah, it is nasty. Have you seen any of the parking attendants who are going to be out there helping people? Are they out there yet, helping people with QR codes?
Yeah, so they're everywhere. So you'll see them, and they're wearing very bright yellow, greenish raincoats, and they are all over the place. They're here to help, and you'll find these QR codes everywhere. So for those, basically those squares with like the little, you know, the black designs on them, those signs are everywhere. You'll see them by the stadium, too. You'll see them on light posts. So you don't even need to do it by where you park. You could actually run to the stadium, and you'll see some of those signs even close to the building as well. So for those who are like worried about, well, I got to get this done quick. Well, if you want to get dry and, you know, run close into the stadium and then scan your code, you can do it that way too.
Very interesting, yeah. So the parking lots are open. That's the breaking news here, opening about 40 minutes or so earlier than scheduled. And that's not uncommon for opening day as the lines start to build up. It's just a flow of traffic kind of thing. I want to know how you drew the short straw, Eric, because I just saw Vetrano take a sip of lemonade standing out by the dugout. You know, he's shaking hands. He's hugging people. And all of a sudden, you're out in the tin box out there dodging puddles.
that's a great point. That's a fantastic point. I'll have to bring that up to him tomorrow morning. What did I do wrong?
Yeah, we'll let him know. We'll send him outside. You need to switch spots with him at this point.
Right, yeah, I'm sure.
Good stuff, Eric.
To you.
Well, have fun out there. Warm up somehow, some way, and get inside the stadium.
He might have jump in that fan's Volvo.
Yeah, right. And go find the Volvo if you can.
Right. I'm looking for Noah. Need an ark.
Yeah, right on. Good stuff, Eric. We'll check in again soon.
See you guys. Happy opening day.
You bet, Eric Bilstead, out in the elements, braving the elements. And look, we've been through this before, Jessica. I don't think tailgating is going to subside. You just have to get a little more creative. You might have to have some sort of tent. And while it may not be pleasant, the spirit of the day is still well alive.
That's the thing. I mean, if you're coming out to opening day here in Wisconsin, you know you can be ready for anything. But I feel like more often than not, we've been dealing with lighter rain or snow. Not necessarily this nasty mess.
I know. When I saw flood watch in my email this morning and then winter weather advisory, like that's just sort of spanning the state here, if you will. Yeah, we're sort of in the middle of all that in Milwaukee.
So thank you to the roof.
Once again, we love it. Once again. Good job, bud. You did great on the roof. Coming up after the break here, we've got Brian Hudson joining us, one of the newest members of the Milwaukee Brewers. He is the tallest member of the Milwaukee Brewers at 6 feet 8 inches. Last year he was with the Dodgers, this year with the Brewers, acquired in the offseason. He is going to be our guest joining us from the dugout right after this. We continue with Opening Day Live presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin after this.
David Nason, host of the Fix-It Show, here with my friend Chris Mancuso, owner of Accurate Basement Repair. Chris, what are some signs of basement problems that need to be addressed?
Hey, David, that's a great question. I would say wall cracks, leaning walls, dark or maybe some discolored stains across the walls. Those are really important things to look at.
As a home inspector, I see this often. Don't wait to call the experts I recommend at Accurate Basement Repair today for your free assessment. They're not just good, they're accurate.
Hey, Eric Bilstead here from Wisconsin's Morning News. So you're thinking about hitting the gym, eh? Or perhaps taking up jogging again, but you're worried. That achy knee, am I right? And you have no interest in surgery. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. No surgery, no drugs, no downtime. So that means getting back to exercising, maybe even running, or even playing 18 holes again. Pain-free. QC Kinetics offers an all-natural solution, no pain pills, and no risky surgery. Reclaim your mobility today. Fix that tennis swing or go back to the gym and know that you won't be dealing with achy joints afterward. Take action now and live your best life this spring and summer. Call QC Kinetics for a free consultation. QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. QC Kinetics.
Sharks. Most people see them as a threat, but we see a potential cure. At UW Health Carbone Cancer Center, we're the only team in the world researching whether antibodies from sharks can be used to fight cancer. A discovery that would revolutionize the future of cancer care, turning possibilities into remarkable realities. So one day, instead of what if, we can ask, what's next? UW Health Carbone Cancer Center. Remarkable.
Why are people saying "Hugh yeah" to Jackson Hewitt? Find out before it's too late. Hurry into Jackson Hewitt today.
I know you have a great dog, right? But you know there's room for improvement. At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we can help. Our attention-based training system uses modern technology to help you better communicate with your dog, even in high distraction. When you schedule a free consultation with us, you will have the opportunity to see our training in action and meet for yourself our happy dogs off-leash and under control. Contact Sit Means Sit today at 262-361-3641 or find us on the web at sitmeanssitwaukesha.com to schedule your free consultation so you can have a happy, confident, and obedient dog.
Get the beat of the Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Your weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks and conversations with the biggest names in basketball. This week, Marcus and his son Chris are joined by Bucks radio voice Dave Kane.
I think that stuff's important for them, but there's also you can't be speaking over the heads of a big chunk of your audience that maybe doesn't know that stuff.
Find Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, or wherever you get your podcast.
Well, so far, we're looking pretty good out on the roads. We do have a broken down vehicle northbound 175 just north of the stadium on the ramp from 94 eastbound, but it's not really affecting your ride since it's out of traffic. We're looking pretty good. Still a little bit tight westbound 894 through that construction zone, but overall, I think we're handling things pretty well. I'm Debbie Lazica with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Brewers opening day live presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Brewers on the field doing some stretching right now. The batting cage is all set up. They'll get guys out here swinging before too long. Twins will take the field eventually here as the pregame continues, all leading up to first pitch. 3:10 today at American Family Field. Jacob Junis will make his first regular season start as a member of the Milwaukee Brewers. And who knows, perhaps Brian Hudson will get an opportunity to come in in relief. Brian Hudson joining us, the Brewers reliever, 6'8" tall, standing in the dugout, nearly hitting his head on the fan. Brian, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Hey, let's go back to the trade day, right? You get through Christmas, you get through New Year's, and you find out on January 3rd that you've been traded from the Dodgers to the Brewers. Can you walk me through what that day was like for you?
It was just a normal day. You know, I woke up, didn't really know what was going to happen. You know, I'd been DFA'd a few days prior, so was just kind of hoping for the best. And I got a call from my agent saying I'd been traded to the Brewers. And, it was extremely exciting. I called my mom, my brother, and they were all really happy and excited I was closer to home so they could come to more games.
Oh, that's fantastic. We love that. This is your first career opening day roster, and you're not the only one on the team. You're actually one of 12, but what does this mean to you?
It means the world to me. It's so exciting. It's everything I've worked up for, and just really happy to be here. We got a really good group of guys, and excited to keep going.
You know, you were drafted by the Cubs. Brian, you were born and raised in Illinois. I have to imagine, actually I don't know this because I know sometimes it's divided in Illinois with Cubs and White Sox fan, but was that a dream to be drafted by a team from your home state?
So for some it would be, but with me growing up in very southern Illinois, I was actually a Cardinals fan growing up. that didn't go over too smooth with some people, but I was fine with it. I was just happy to be there.
Yeah, and now you get an opportunity for your family to come enjoy you here in Milwaukee. So, you know, it's a different spring training for you that you just got out of. You go from the Dodgers to the Brewers here. Are there big differences with how teams operate during spring training and just sort of, you know, the general vibe in a clubhouse?
There's always a little bit of difference, but overall the goal is to win. You know, every day we come in with that mindset and we go out there and put our best foot forward and try to get that done. So it's kind of, you know, different in ways of just people are different, go about their work differently, but it's all the same goal in the end.
Greg mentioned your height at 6'8". This isn't basketball, but your height does help you. How is being 6'8" a benefit in baseball?
I think it just gives a different look, you know. Just a different look. I'm throwing from a very far side of the rubber. And my extension, I think, helps me get on some hitters. And, I think it just plays to my advantage.
Yeah, a lot of people wearing name tags during spring training, Brian, as this young team gets to know one another. Have you been in a clubhouse like that before where there's been so many young faces, some making their major league debut, some just barely cracking into their major league career?
I have not. So this is all a really new experience for me, and it's been great so far. You know, there's a really good group of guys, and we're all just looking forward to keeping it rolling.
It seems like Pat keeps people on their toes too, right? You never quite know if he's serious or joking because he's sort of the same kind of tone to his conversations.
Yeah, you know, I gotta learn how to read him, but yes, he always keeps me on my toes. We're only a handful of games in, but he keeps me on my toes for sure.
Listening to Pat this morning right here on 620 WTMJ, I felt like he tells you like it is, though. Is that the case?
Yeah, he doesn't sugarcoat it. He is a straight shooter, and, I really appreciate that because in this game, you want to be told how it is, and that's how you go out, get better, so I like it.
One of the other things when I was looking up the stats on you, Brian, is you're a lefty. For all the casual fans out there, why does being a left-handed pitcher matter?
I think it just changes, you know, most hitters, in a sense, are righties, and I think it just gives them a different angle. They're always used to seeing the ball come from the right side, and then I get up there and I kind of funky, so I get to mix it up a little bit and hopefully help that next guy.
Well, we were appreciative of climate-controlled conditions here. I know it was a little nasty in New York, and your season was delayed in getting up and running. But, boy, what a great feeling starting not only with three straight wins, but getting those on the road, Brian. That's an impressive start to the season. Couldn't ask for anything better.
Yeah, those were three really good wins, and it fired the guys up, and I think we're all just ready to keep it rolling. I mean, we started out on the right foot, and we're gonna keep going.
Well, thanks for joining us here today. I know you got big things to get to, and looking forward to the opening day introductions and you being a part of that, Brian. Thanks for joining us.
All righty. Thank you for having me.
Yep, you bet. Brian Hudson, Brewers reliever, one of many new faces, as you mentioned, Jessica. So 12 opening day, never been through it before situations on the Brewers roster here, including Brian, who's been in the league but never with the Brewers and never on an opening day roster.
Yeah, so many exciting things happening for him. We didn't have enough time to get to this, but also he's engaged. His fiance's name is Kaylin, and just on Instagram, they showed a little picture of the two of them. I think he got down on his knee and popped the question, and so you've got that, his engagement, and then today, his first career opening day roster. That's just awesome.
That's cool. A lot of those stories here as you get to know this Brewers team that comes home with three straight wins to begin the season. You love to see that. Hey, never too early to start winning in Major League Baseball, that is for sure. It's 11:52 on WTMJ. We've been hinting at this and telling you about it really for the better part of the day and really the last several weeks. New parking at American Family Field. You're likely in your car right now. If you're not in the lots, you maybe are on your way. What do you need to know? We've got all the details coming up after this.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame, Dollar, Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokunbo sits down with special guests on Thanalysis Show. Presented by Potawatomi Casino Hotel.
Fantastic.
Find Thanalysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching Thanalysis Show.
The savings really do add up. Last I checked, we've saved our clients over $7.5 million in real estate commissions. And we'd like to add your savings to the tally. All the same experience, expertise, and know-how as the big-name real estate firms. We just choose to charge you less. As low as 3.5% commission and no higher than 3.9%. Or a full-service real estate agent, including full MLS marketing with no upfront fees. This is Angela Calais with Benefit Realty, where we'll make your move simple and affordable. Benefit-realty.com. When we begin your search, I'm not going to try to sell you anything because it's either the right home for you or it's not. What counts is that you'll have an honest, full-service realtor looking out for your best interests. So think of Benefit Realty as your advocates, which offer full-service real estate commission as low as 3.5% and no higher than 3.9%, including full MLS marketing with no upfront fees. I'm Angela Calais with Benefit Realty, where we'll make your move simple and affordable. Benefit-realty.com.
Haul away big deals this Thursday through Sunday at Fleet Farm's Truckload Savings Event. Like 40-pound bags of black oil sunflower seed on sale for $14.99. Save on a Blackstone 28-inch griddle with cover and accessories, just $249.99. Pick up 4 bags of garden soil on sale for $10. And save on 40 pounds of Morton water softening pellets for only $5.79. Stock up on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Good time with you. It is Brewers Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, inside American Family Field. Got a good portion of the team out on the field going through their early stretching and getting loosened up here. I see Christian Yelich up there.
Gotta get loose.
The yellow shoes are a popular thing here. I see several players, including Willy Adames, with bright yellow shoes. So if the lights ever went out inside the stadium, we'd be fine so long as Willy Adames has his feet and those shoes on those feet out in the field somewhere. Very bright.
I like that a lot because a lot of times when you're watching the Bucks games, they've got very colorful shoes, and a lot of the team does. But here, it's not as many, so it really sticks out even more.
It absolutely does. So one of many things we are watching and witnessing inside the stadium. On the outside, the parking lots are now open about 40 minutes earlier than expected or scheduled as fans start to work their way inside American Family Field's parking lots. And keep in mind, it's a new system. Here's what you need to know. Everything you need to know about the new parking at American Family Field.
Okay, we all know the debacle parking at AmFam Field has been in the past, but it looks like things are about to change.
There's no transaction to get into the lots with an attendant.
Brewers Executive Vice President and Chief Commercial Officer Jason Hartland says it's all about making things flow smoothly.
It is about getting people out of lines and out of cars more quickly and into the parking lots for tailgating and into the ballpark. When people come to the game, it's an investment of time, and we don't want that time to be spent behind the steering wheel.
So since there's been bottlenecks around the parking lots in the past, how exactly is this going to work?
You'll enter the lots as you normally would. The difference is there's no transaction with a cashier for cash or credit card. You will determine what lot you want to park in, whether it's preferred, gold, or general, and a parking ambassador will help you get to that spot. At that point, you'll get out of your car, look at one of the light poles in the lot you're in, and scan the QR code. At that point, it's extremely intuitive. If you've pre-purchased, you're entering your license plate information and activating the parking. If you haven't, there's a couple more steps with credit card information, expiration date, things of that nature, and then you activate your parking. Piece of cake.
Those QR codes are everywhere, on every light post, on A-frame signs, literally all over. Plus,
there'll be parking attendants and ambassadors that'll help you get to the spot you want to get to.
So all questions can be answered. But what if you don't have a smartphone or you don't have a way to pay with a credit card?
There are pay stations around the property, and a parking ambassador can help direct you to one, or you can pay cash.
But if you're at all worried and want to save a little money,
if you purchase ahead of time, it is less expensive than day of. And the parking fees do vary based on day of the week and weekend opponent, things of that nature. You can find all the parking information on brewers.com/parking.
Wondering how they enforce these things?
The technology is actually amazing. So there's cameras throughout the parking lots that have license plate technology, and it reconciles in real time as to people who have entered the lots and those who have activated their parking.
If they find that you've not paid, you will get a ticket.
If you don't pay at all, as I mentioned, there are the cameras, and they reconcile in real time with the license plates and cars that have come into the lot, and it compares it to those that have paid. 30 minutes after first pitch, Interstate will be going around and enforcing parking. And if you haven't paid, it'll be whatever the price would cost for your individual lot plus a $3 fine.
By the way, if you think it's an error, you can call Interstate Parking and they can go back in the camera feeds to see if it's really accurate or not. All in all, not having to stop until you get to your spot should be a game changer. See what I did there? All in the interest of getting you in for the two most important things on this type of outing, tailgating and the game. Debbie Lozaga, WTMJ News.
Burkhart Sporting Goods in New Berlin is the baseball lover's destination. With a massive state-of-the-art indoor training facility featuring hit tracks with precision analytics, a huge open turf area, and all the best training equipment you need. So get in here and get ready to get better. And we'll help you with this special offer. Buy 20 batting cage credits for $30. That's 25% off. This is Brian Burkhart, and if you love baseball and softball like we do,
you can't beat Burkhart.
153rd and National. If you plan on draining buzzer beaters, the place to start is Burkhart, where you'll find a great selection of residential basketball hoops from the best brand, Goalrilla. We'll handle the installation and take care of everything to make it easy from start to finish. And right now, when you buy from Burkhart, standard hoop installation is half price. Only $250 for standard installation. You can't beat that. This is Brian Burkhart, and when you love basketball like we do,
you can't beat Burkhart.
New Berlin and Fox Point.
From big tailgate parties to cozy dinners for two, the freshest ideas start with a stop at Century Foods.
Now through Wednesday, save on 1.38 to 11.36 or 8-count selected varieties, Frito-Lay Lays, kettle chips, munchies, or bean dip, 2 for $5. 24-pack Ice Mountain Spring Water, $4.99. 8.2 to 20-ounce selected varieties, C-Pack Seafood, $6.99. 4-count selected varieties, Dan and Greek or Danimals Yogurt, 2 for $8.
Mm. Why'd you throw my glass across the room?
I have to keep practicing.
The vase from Aunt Sophie?
I'm warming up in case I get to take the mound at American Family Field. Read this.
Win the ultimate baseball fan experience at Century Foods?
You either get to throw out the first pitch, hold the finish line for the famous racing sausages, or be on the field during batting practice. My new TV!
Just doing a little batting practice of my own.
The ultimate baseball fan experience. Return the entry form found in the weekly ad to any Century by July 24th.
For WTMJ contest rules, visit WTMJ.com/contests.
The crew are finally back in Milwaukee, which means it's time for the real opening day.
Hit deep, deep to left field, backing up Nimmo, turning, watching it sail. Goodbye!
The Brewers' home opener begins against the Twins at American Family Field. Our coverage starts today at 2:35 on your home for the Brewers. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 12 o'clock, it's 38 degrees. A Fleet Farm storm team alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. Snow turning into snow from rain as we head through the afternoon. Eventually, all of southeast Wisconsin ends up with snow. On this opening day at home and spring election day, more on both of those in a moment, but first more on the weather. That nasty weather hitting southeast Wisconsin today will impact both the spring elections and tailgating. Storm Team 4 meteorologist Tyler Moore says those heading out to vote or leaving the ballgame today will be contending with wet and heavy snowfall.
If you're heading west on 94 or heading on 43 northbound, keep that in mind that you're really going to be looking at some difficulties with some heavy wet snow coming down. It continues through the evening hours and continues to ramp up throughout the overnight hours tonight as this band of snow will sit over eastern portions of Wisconsin.
Your complete WTMJ five-day forecast is coming up. That nasty weather isn't deterring fans from piling into the American Family Field parking lots ahead of today's Brewers home opener.
It's rainy, it's windy, it's downright miserable. There's no reason to be outside. Unless, of course, you're a diehard tailgater outside American Family Field.
We've been here through the snow, we've been here through the wind. We had wood chips in our vehicle a few years back because it was so windy. It was taking the wood chips off the planters and loading them into vehicles. We're here.
These guys have been here since 9 a.m. and they ain't going anywhere.
What's the biggest challenge of these conditions?
Staying warm, but we got it. We got it.
Outside American Family Field, Eric Bilstead, WDTMJ News.
One way to stay out of the rain is to take the shuttle. Victor Weber's been driving a shuttle for Kelly's Bleachers for 15 years and tells WTMJ it's a fun way to get to the park.
We run an average of 3 shuttles every game, so they're always in rotation. One's leaving, the other one's loading up, the other one's pulling up. So you're waiting maybe 10 minutes at the most. It takes about 6 minutes to get down there for an average. Every shuttle driver has a little certain stick, like someone tells jokes. Someone has karaoke on their shuttle. I have trivia on my shuttle. It's just be part of everybody, make it enjoyable on the way down and get everybody pumped up for the baseball game.
Shuttles run all day from many of the local bars and restaurants. On the field, there are plenty of new faces and new places, among them Brewers outfielder Blake Perkins, who joined Wisconsin's Midday News.
I'm just extremely grateful and very excited to be here and be a part of it and just to take it all in and support my teammates and get a win.
And Brewers manager Pat Murphy, who's been part of plenty of home openers, but never is the main man.
This is a life work. It's something I love. You know, I have a great staff around me, guys that I'm familiar with. So this has been a fun thing. We've got an uphill battle, and we got to figure some things out, but we're heading in the right direction.
Brewers radio network coverage starts at 2:35 right here on WTMJ. Today's also the spring primary. Wisconsin's chief elections official Megan Wolf reminds voters about polling times for Election Day.
Polls are open until 8 p.m. across the state. And voters who are in line by that time still have the right to cast their ballot.
Voters need to bring a valid photo ID to get that ballot.
Your ID should be unexpired, or in the case of some, like a Wisconsin driver license, it can still be used if it expired after November 8th. Of 2022.
And having that state-issued ID is critical for voting today.
I'm at the Milwaukee Central DMV location off of Chase Avenue on the south side of Milwaukee, and the longest part of getting a temporary Wisconsin license that I can take to my polling location was waiting in line to get up to the desk. Now that I've got my temporary license as a former Illinois resident, I can head to my polling location to get registered to vote. All told, I was at the DMV for about an hour. Jack Grab, WTMJ News.
And the DMV extended hours until 6 o'clock today, so folks could get those IDs. Time for news about your money, the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Rough day. The S&P is off 44 points. The Dow right now is down 448, and the NASDAQ is off 173 points. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com, click the Get Started button today. Sports traffic and weather up next. Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 12:05. News is Greg sponsored Matzik
here for Holiday Automotive in Fond du Lac. Hey, Holiday opened its doors to Wisconsin drivers back in 1959 as a trusted place to buy and service a vehicle powered by a team of caring individuals. 65 years later, that tradition proudly lives on. Connect with Holiday and join the celebration during their 65th anniversary sale. Explore all that's new from Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC, or check out the terrific value and peace of mind benefits of a GM-certified pre-owned model. Team Holiday's genuine hospitality and passion for helping and delighting guests has been making fans of Badger State drivers for over six decades. That's a lot of fans, and I'm one of them. You'll be in great hands with Wisconsin's number one Buick and GMC dealer on your side. Accolades are per 2023 Buick and GMC zone sales records. Find yours and discover the difference at Holiday Chevrolet, Buick and GMC, Highway 41 and 23 in Fond du Lac, and at HolidayGM.com. It's worth the trip.
News is sponsored by Holiday Automotive, Highway 23 in Fond du Lac. Holiday Automotive, it's worth the trip.
Visit family-owned Ken Michaels Furniture and our in-store design centers where you'll still find beautiful, luxurious, heirloom quality American-made furniture. Right now, save 30 to 35% store-wide and take advantage of our complimentary design services. Whether you're moving, renovating, or updating, our designers will help your vision become a reality. Visit Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield on Capitol Drive and in Greenfield on Highway 100 to save 30 to 35% store-wide today. Sleep better and save more with mattresses from Milwaukee Mattress and Ken Michaels Furniture. Handcrafted in our Milwaukee factory, our mattresses utilize natural materials like cotton cushioning, which dissipates body heat, Joma wool quilts for warm wintry nights and cool summer evenings, and natural latex providing superior conformability and pressure relief for aching joints. Stop in today at any Ken Michaels Furniture store and save up to 50% compared to national brands.
Time for a WTMJ Sports Update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. It's finally home opening day for the Brewers. Parking opens in just a few minutes. The gates open at 1:10, and we are live from American Family Field until our Brewers Radio Network coverage starts at 2:35. Bob Uecker will be on the mic for today's home opening ball game. Let's check those roads. Debbie Lozaga, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Well, we have a bit of a mess out there. Westbound 94 right now, they have shut it down basically just west of Highway SS in Waukesha because of a crash. Now, they are still letting some cars go through, but I think that's just to relieve the pressure right behind where the accident is. So keep that in mind. We've also got a problem, 894 southbound, just south of Beloit Road, two left lanes blocked there because of a crash. And one more crash on northbound 41. Just north of Silver Spring. That one at least is out of traffic on the right shoulder. The rest of the system, for the most part, not looking too bad, especially right around the stadium. Starting to see a little bit of building volume, but I'm telling you, you're actually able to get in there relatively smoothly. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Traffic is brought to you by Rejuvenix, your non-surgical joint therapy experts.
Rejuvenex.com to request your appointment.
Your Storm Team 4 5-day forecast of Fleet Farm Storm Team Alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory has been issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. Right now, windy and rainy. That changes to snow from the northwest into the metro area. High of 39. The snow really ramps up tonight. Accumulation is 6 to 9 inches in Beaver Dam and West Bend, less as you get towards the city. Tomorrow, snow tapers off, a high of 37. Thursday, rain, a high of 41. Friday, mostly sunny, 43. On Saturday, mostly sunny, a high of 46 degrees. Right now in Madison, rainy and 36 degrees. In Green Bay, a little rain snow mix, it's 37. In Waukesha, rainy and 36 degrees. I'm John Merkier, Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 1210.
From American Family Field, it's Brewers Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Now, here are your hosts, Jessica Tai and Greg Matzik.
Well, welcome back in. It's hour number two of Wisconsin's Midday News, opening day version of Wisconsin's Midday News. The light's a little brighter inside the stadium now, and in less than an hour, Jessica, or about an hour, I should say,
The gates will be open. We know the parking lots are open here at American Family Field, but soon the gates will be open, and the fans who are in the lots will start streaming into the ballpark. We're going to have baseball here in 3 hours.
Baseball coming up right now on the field. The players are out there. They are practicing. We've got the broadcast teams all out and about, and oh, what was it, about 50 minutes ago, we also had pyrotechnics.
Yeah.
That was fun to see. All of a sudden, it was just flashes by the Brewers dugout. Everything's okay. They're getting ready for a little something fancy.
Yeah,
today.
Nothing caught on fire that we know anyway. But yes, you'll want to be in here early to see all the things happening here on opening day, which is our big story here that we are covering.
Now at noon, Brewers Edition on Wisconsin's Midday News.
The parking lots are officially open now here at American Family Field as rain continues to fall in the city of Milwaukee. First pitch for today's home opener is 3:10 this afternoon. We're getting you ready for it all here on Wisconsin's Midday News. Some details to let you know about: the Milwaukee Symphony String Quartet will perform the national anthem. And all fans coming to the ballpark today will get a Brewers Magnet schedule presented by Palermo's Pizza. It's always nice, Greg, to put that schedule right there in your fridge and
love that.
Keep on track with everything that's coming up.
It'll be a collection of cancer survivors throwing out the first pitches today before the game. And if you're making your way toward the ballpark, we know they opened the lots a little bit early. A reminder that the parking situation is different. So the lots ended up opening about 11:40 or so. Regardless of if you've purchased parking in advance or plan to purchase it today on site, you're going to have to scan that QR code upon arrival. So whether you get your car parked first, then find the QR code, whatever way you want to do it that's easiest for you, you're going to have to do that today. So it's different and likely more efficient, which I think is what the Brewers are aiming for here. There'll be a bunch of parking ambassadors on site to assist with the process as the gates are now officially open. For those who are hoping to get in a little early, your wish was granted.
And speaking of giveaways down the road, the first homestand of the season welcomes the first gate giveaway. The first 30,000 ticketed fans for Saturday's game against the Mariners get an exclusive Giannis Antetokounmpo Brewers basketball jersey that's presented by ESPN Milwaukee.
Very cool. Yeah, that's a big one. That is a big one here as the Brewers open up with a 5-game homestand. All American League teams, by the way. You got the Twins, you got the Mariners. I like the idea of a border rivalry to kick things off. I think it's kind of cool the Twins are in town here. Another team used to playing in adverse conditions, no doubt about that. But a fun way. You know the stadium's going to be packed regardless, but now you get that little sense of rivalry with the Twins in town. That's a fun way to begin.
You know what else I love? Hall of Fame announcer Bob Uecker. He's going to be on the mic for the first pitch of 2024. He is 90 years old at this point, still going strong. He enters his 54th season as a broadcaster for his hometown team, calling games right here on 620 WTMJ.
Looking forward to that. So first pitch scheduled for 3:10. Jacob Junis is the starting pitcher for the Brewers today as the lineups have just come out. And before too long, the Twins will be on the field getting their pregame activities on. Should be a packed house here at American Family Field. Outside of American Family Field, at least I think anyway, he was inside for a minute. Now I think he is outside. We're going to check in with Vince Vitrano coming up in just a few minutes as we're starting to fill up on the outside of the stadium. Before too long, the inside will be packed here as well. We'll check in with Vinny after this on Wisconsin's Midday News.
He asked,
if I could be a host on WTMJ's Wisconsin's Morning News, I think that would really be the pinnacle of my career.
So we answered. Jeff Levering is our Brewers 360 guest every Wednesday at 7:45.
I don't know how I could call a game without the suggestions I get from Eric and Vince.
So in Arizona, you could drop a, I was in the pool, if the ball lands in the little pool.
Oh, outstanding.
If they hit a home run. So there you go. You're welcome.
On Wisconsin's Morning News, sponsored by Outdoor Living Unlimited and Holiday Automotive.
Well, it's maybe lunchtime where you are at. Maybe you're ready to get down for a later lunch than usual and enjoy the game today. Whether it's a late lunch or an early dinner, it's Palermo's, Wisconsin's hometown pizza. Boy, it tastes perfect on a day like today, wouldn't it? Urban Pie, Connie's, the Surfer Boy pizza, Screamin' Sicilian, I absolutely love it. There's stuff in the crust of that thing now. Amazing, from Palermo's, made in Wisconsin, and celebrating its 60th anniversary in 2024. 60 years of doing it right, making the best-tasting frozen pizzas you can find. Wherever you like to shop, you will no doubt find Palermo's, Wisconsin's hometown pizza, at Festival Foods, Pick and Save, Sendix, Piggly Wiggly, Woodman's, and more. You're never too far away from a great meal. And it's Palermo's. Everyone's happy when it's a Palermo's night in your household. Fill up the freezer, put one in the oven tonight, one on the table for dinner. Everyone's happy with Palermo's, Wisconsin's hometown pizza.
Tune in on Sundays at 10 a.m. for the Acunet Mortgage and Realty Show. Join Acunet's Brian and David Wickard for the most up-to-date information on mortgage trends, along with timely news on the real estate market. The housing market is in flux, but the national headlines don't often fit local market conditions. Find out what's really happening on the front lines of real estate and mortgage financing in Wisconsin and make better decisions by tuning in every Sunday at 10 a.m. The Acunet Mortgage and Realty Show with Brian and David Wickard on WTMJ.
Yeah, we've got westbound on 94 still kind of blocked off at Highway SS or west of with a crash there. So just be prepared for some delays heading through that area, also affecting your eastbound ride as well. Right around the stadium interchange, got to tell you, you're looking good. So far, so good. Some of those lots like the Molitor lot and Spahn lot, those are starting to get filled in. So far, so good. Back onto the freeway, though, we do have a crash on 41 northbound, just north of Silver Spring, off on the right shoulder. And then we've got the other one on 894 southbound, south of Beloit Road. Two left lanes are blocked. So those delays are already stretching almost to National Avenue. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody.
Brewers Opening Day Live presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. We are inside American Family Field. Greg Matzik and Jessica Tye until 1 o'clock. And about the time we sign off, the gates will open to American Family Field. Fans are going to be streaming in. Jessica, they've been streaming into the parking lot here over the next over the past 25, 35 minutes or so.
The Brewers do have a habit of opening the gates to the parking lots just a little bit earlier than they say they're going to, which is always nice. And I wondered if that would change this year because they do have a new parking system. And at some point, we believe that it should go, you know, as perfect as they hope it will be, and things will be more efficient and even faster. So I didn't know if they would need to open them even earlier, but today, you know what, let's get things started early. Let's do it.
They did. They opened about 11:40. That was the time we were checking in with Eric Bilstead, and we noted with Eric that Vince Vetrano was inside the stadium as Eric was decomposing outside of the stadium,
sipping on some lemonade, as you noted.
I don't know where Vinny is right now, but he joins us. Hi Vince, where are you?
I'm outside. I'm doing my job. I just wanted to stop in and get a feel for a minute. But I am, well, I may be under a tent, but I'm out. I am outdoors.
Oh, you are outdoors. So are you under a tailgater's tent? Like, what are you doing?
You know where I am, guys? I'm at the home plate entrance to the ballpark, and you know they have the tented area for the security screening. And I got about 24 fans who are already in line waiting to be first inside the ballpark. The gate cannot open soon enough for them.
Yeah, that is the truth. This is a character builder outside, isn't it?
Oh, man. Greg, you and I have been around. Jess, you grew up here. I mean, it's been a lot of crummy opening days in terms of the weather, but I tell you what, this ranks in the top five, maybe. Not good out there.
Top five as far as the worst weather.
Yeah, top five most worst.
That's what I was thinking, because, I mean, I remember, you know, and you were out here too, Vinny, so many opening days where we were out early, and sometimes it would be snow or be cold. That's usually what you're worrying about. But what is it like right now? Paint the picture for us outside, because when we walked in earlier, it was windy, it was wet, the rain was coming down hard, and there were puddles. You were walking through puddles and salt that was put down too.
Wondering whether or not I'm going to go back to the car for another pair of socks, because this is kind of weather where you just can't stay dry. So I'm looking out of the parking lots, and some folks have their tents up for the tailgate. They're going to do it. But like I said, here at the home plate entrance, now probably about 36 fans who've just decided, forget it. We parked. We're going to walk here, hoping maybe they might open the gates a little bit early. The problem with that is, as you guys know, you got concessions, and they have to do their full setup and stuff. So if they're not ready for people to be in the ballpark, they're not going to open up early. So it might just be a chilly wait for all the folks here.
You know, it's a great opportunity maybe to enjoy some of the outskirts of American Family Field, some of the bars and restaurants that will offer free shuttles and whatnot. Just, you know, go in, get your tap of Miller Lite and a burger or something, and then hop on a free shuttle.
Yeah, the outskirts, as you say. And I'm watching the shuttles. They're starting to pull up, but I'm guessing you want to be on one of the late shuttles today, at least until the gates open up.
Yeah, or Uber here, that's always easy too. Definitely not taking a bubbler bike here today.
No. Well,
that is a good option when it's nice out. Vince, who's the most passionate fan that you've seen out there right now as that rain just continues to come down?
It's so hard to say because it is a bit subdued. People are legit cold. But I talked to a whole family. They just came here from West Bend. They were some of the first in the parking lot and just said they wanted to be first inside. So they are fired up. The 50-50 raffle guy, he's not cold. He's just got a sweatshirt on. He's out here enjoying it. But folks are ready to get warm. Are y'all ready to get warm?
Yeah! I don't care about the weather.
Oh, I'm sorry. They don't care about the weather. Everybody's fine then.
Maybe he had a couple Miller Lights already.
They might be getting warm in a different way. That's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. Have you located Bill Stead? We were okay. Well, that's good. We were worried about Bill Stead. Have you located him yet? He didn't. He sounded like it was a rough go.
I have not located Eric. I did text him before because, you know, we got the WTMJ tailgater out here where, you know, we are usually doing our work. And that's kind of boarded up at the moment. It's looking very lonely.
It's boarded up because of the wind and the rain.
Well, I mean,
it's like
right,
if the snow came down, we could be in there. But
I tell you what, I'd take snow almost at this point. I mean, you wouldn't want to accumulate because it'd be rough getting home. But like it's. Snow's not going to soak you all the way through. This is just that deep soak driving rain, and it's real ugly. But I mean, again, people are fired up. They're ready for it, and we got the roof, so it's all good. I mean, we're like 22 years in this ballpark. I feel like the roof somehow still feels like a novelty.
It does. It's our savior. Roof for the win today.
This has happened before. It'll happen again. No doubt about it. Vinny, get warm. We will talk to you soon. Thank you.
Am I clear to come inside now, Greg? Is that okay?
Yes, you may. Bring Eric with you, though. My goodness, I feel bad for the man.
Get some dry socks.
Good stuff. Well, we've got Julian Johnson out and about. We're going to check in with him next. You talk about the shuttle options available. There are many in the outskirts of American Family Field coming in from Blue Mound Road. So Julian is in that mix. He got the best assignment as far as I'm concerned. We'll check in with him coming up after this. It's 12:22 on WTMJ.
Hey, John Mercier here for Floor Coverings International. They just did the flooring in our house, and it is stunning. Carpet, luxury vinyl plank, in and out quickly. They rolled up with that mobile flooring showroom. Incredible. Came in, walked us through everything. The installation was quick and easy, and it is absolutely gorgeous. FCI, the stars of flooring. Each Floor Covering International business is independently owned and operated. They are the real deal. Go to FCIfloors.com for a free consultation. They'll transform your home. FCIfloors.com.
Now me for my good friends at Pottawatomie Casino Hotel, right in the heart of downtown Milwaukee. A great stop before the game, after the game, or even during the game. In fact, at Pottawatomie, there is a table waiting for you. 12 bars, restaurants, winning seats are available. 40 table games, over 3,000 slot machines. You can play bingo. They've got full-service sports betting and an incredible sports book, which is coming. So are you ready for something new? Spark up your senses a little bit. Pottawatomie Casino Hotel is the place to go. We spent a lot of time there during the football season at Rockin' Brews with our weekly football show. An amazing place on the fourth floor, and it's smoke-free. Did I mention that? It's incredible. It's paysbig.com, paysbig.com. Explore more at paysbig.com and make a visit to Pottawatomie Casino Hotel.
This is Matt Meitner, owner of Sit Means Sit Dog Training. Do you find yourself talking to your dog but feel like she's not listening to you?
Bella, sit!
Are you constantly repeating yourself but she's not following your directions?
Sit! Sit!
Frustrating, isn't it? At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we want to help you have a happy, confident, and obedient dog. And we also want to make the training process an enjoyable and worthwhile experience. Contact Sit Means Sit today to schedule a free consultation so we can create a customized training program so you are able to have the dog you want and deserve.
Sit Means Sit Dog Training. Sorry, we don't train husbands, wives, or kids.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella Windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Glory days, will it pass you by?
Brewers Opening Day Live presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Greg Matzik and Jessica Tai with you from American Family Field. We know the parking lots are open. If you're having any issues with trying to activate your parking, the Brewers recommend you periodically try and attempt to connect. But in the meantime, parking ambassadors will be going through each lot with handheld scanners, and that'll help assist fans trying to get through the system as they launch this thing today, day one, for thousands and thousands of cars that'll be piling into the parking lot. So if you are experiencing issues trying to activate your parking, you are free to try and do it periodically. But in the meantime, if you see a parking ambassador walking by, just flag that person down and they'll have a handheld scanner that can assist you. So keep that in mind as you're coming into the lots today.
The nice thing too, a lot of these parking ambassadors, they're very easy to see. They've got raincoats on, a lot of them in yellow, some of them in red.
Yeah.
Easy to spot out there.
No doubt about that. I don't know if Julian Johnson has got a wetsuit on or a rain suit of any kind, but he is at Kelly's Bleachers. He is part of the bar crowd, the shuttle crowd, making its way to American Family Field. Hey, Julian, what's the scene like, and where are you at?
Again, I'm at Kelly's Bleachers at the moment. I'm outside. They got an outside tent. They got the inside area. You got people chilling outside. I mean, it's a lot going on. I mean, I got here about, 10:15-ish, and it is packed now. I'm talking about both sides are packed, and people just cannot wait for this game. They're excited.
Have the first shuttle started rolling out, or is that to come yet?
Actually, I'm walking over here right now. One of them has already left. They got another guy. He's actually his first time back shuttling after a year. He actually broke his neck, and he said he loved this whole atmosphere and everything. So, and he loves the people and everything. But, yeah, they're about to leave the other shuttle about right now, and then there's going to be three different rows of them coming out in and out throughout before the game.
It doesn't matter if it's windy, if it's rainy, if there are puddles galore. We have diehard fans here in Milwaukee and across the state of Wisconsin. Have you talked to some of them out there, the people having just a blast this morning before the game even begins at Kelly's Bleachers?
Yeah, I've talked to a lot of them. I mean, one of them, his name is Matthew. He actually is like, he lived in London for a little bit, and he's coming here. This is his first ever home opener here. And he's been here since the beginning. He said he appreciates being punctual. So that's why he wanted to get here before all the stuff so he can get his parking spot. And I met another lady who's done 20 straight of these home openers at Kelly specifically as well. And some other people like that also. I mean, they're really serious about their brew crew. And, you know, I am too at this point.
Julian, I'm wondering if you've come across anybody who had to bail on their tailgating plans and make a bar/shuttle the way to go today, just given the weather.
I'm sorry, you say that one more time?
Yeah, I'm wondering if you met anybody who had ideas of tailgating but decided to punt on that idea just given the weather.
Oh, not exactly. No, I mean, everybody kind of just kept on with their plans and everything. I mean, they said rain, sleet, or snow, as Jessica was saying. They're here, and they're going to do exactly what they need to do.
I think a lot of times those shuttles are booked out. It's like, you snooze, you lose. Yeah,
right.
Our shuttles are booked. But I think you're right, Greg, about the bar. You might find some people who are like, you know what, I got to be inside today. But you said there's an outside tent as well. Is that popping right now as we're close to 12:30?
Yeah, it's popping. It is popping. When I first came in there around like 11:30-ish, because that's when I first came out there, it was like a little barren still. But now there's a whole bunch of people. They got all the people with the drinks and everything, and just they're having a phenomenal time. I see some Twins fans here as well, so you know they know how to get down apparently too.
They knew where to go because Kelly Bleachers is
that's
a popular
exactly
place.
It. That
go
is
to
exactly
Kelly's
it.
Game.
Julian, good stuff, man. You got the fun assignment today. We'll check in again soon. Thank you so much.
All right, no problem. Have a good one.
You bet. Coming up before 1 o'clock, Brewers principal owner Mark Attanasio is scheduled to join us. We do have Spanning the State broadcasting live from the studio as well. I know they've got GM Matt Arnold scheduled to appear as we get closer to network coverage, which begins about 2:30 here on WTMJ. The news is next.
My doctor told me my cholesterol is borderline, so I took control with Garlique Healthy Cholesterol Formula. Garlique helps maintain healthy cholesterol safely and naturally. It's odor and taste-free, and Garlique is a world leader in garlic potency. I'm taking charge of my cholesterol with Garlique Healthy Cholesterol Formula, cholesterol's natural enemy.
These statements have not been evaluated by the FDA. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. The term natural reference is only the garlic in the product. Use as directed.
If spring allergies keep you trapped inside, then you need Navage Nasal Care to keep you breathing clearly and enjoying all the beauties of spring. Navage helps clear nasal passages that are often clogged because of seasonal allergies. Navage gently flushes a pure, refreshing saline solution through your nasal passages to clear out congestion, sucking out that springtime pollen and other irritants trapped in your nose. Navage is available online at Navage.com or in stores at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, and Target. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E.
With crippling inflation, the locally owned Mein Chef restaurant in Hartford has the best Tuesday dining value anywhere. WTMJ's John Merkier here. The all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet is just $9.99. It's all your favorite authentic Mexican food for $9.99. Kids and grandkids, 5 and under, eat free from the kids' menu. Sunday through Thursday, they can safely play in that huge game room while you finish up your all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet. The Mein Chef is super affordable and very family-friendly. The Wednesday and Friday fish fry is now just $4.99. That's a crazy low price, $4.99. Stop today for the Tuesday all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet for $9.99. Desserts are always buy one, get one free. Come early today. From 2 till 5, cocktails, beers, and appetizers are half price. The Mein Chef in beautiful downtown Hartford and in Oshkosh. It's big food. It's big fun. It's the Mein Chef. No reservations needed. Just walk on in. MeinChefRestaurant.com. Sighting Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 12:31. Today's opening day. It's also election day. First, the polls. Voters will make choices in everything from the presidential primary to their local school board. There are also two constitutional amendments that deal with outside money and elections in the state, as well as 100 tax increase questions, including a big referendum for Milwaukee Public Schools. Polls are open until 8 o'clock. The national political scene coming to Wisconsin today. Former President Donald Trump scheduled to make an appearance at the Hyatt Regency in Green Bay this afternoon. And the White House says President Biden will visit Madison on Monday, April 8th. On to opening day. The parking lots are now open out at American Family Field. Stadium gates open at 1:10. The pregame coverage on WTMJ at 2:30 with a ceremonial first pitch at 3:03. Official first pitch at 3:10. Bob Uecker will be on the call. Time for news about your money and the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Lots of red today. The S&P 500 currently down 48 points. The Dow is off 491. That's 1.25%. The NASDAQ falling. It's at 185 off on the day. That's down more than 1%. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. Debbie Lozaga has a look at your roads. It's been a tricky one, Deb.
It has been. Luckily, though, westbound 94, that earlier closure just west of Highway SS, now it's just the right lane that's blocked. Tow truck emergency crews are on scene with this accident just west of SS. We do still have this other one on 894 southbound off on the right shoulder now, just south of Beloit Road. It was blocking some lanes of traffic. Now we just have delays pretty much back from National Avenue down past that point. Closer into the stadium, so far we are looking at a pretty good ride. We're not seeing too many delays around the area. Some of the lots are starting to fill in a little bit, like the Spahn lot, also Molitor lot. I saw some cars rolling in there to get filled in. So just to keep that in mind, if you're worried about it, just get out there a little bit earlier. That way you can handle the whole parking thing. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Your Storm Team 4 5-day forecast. A Fleet Farm Storm Team alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. Rain will change to snow for everybody as we head closer to the dinner hour, a high of 39 degrees today. The snow really ramps up overnight. North and west of the city could get upwards of 6 inches of snow. Tomorrow, snow in the morning. It does taper off, a high of 37. On Thursday, rain, a high of 41. Friday, sunny, 43. On Saturday, mostly sunny, a high of 46 degrees. Right now in Madison, rainy and 36 degrees. In Green Bay, it's already transitioned to snow and 36 degrees. Waukesha, rain 36 degrees. In Milwaukee, kind of a sloppy mess and 38 degrees. I'm John Merkier, Sighting Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 12:34.
Brewer
Brewers Opening Day Live presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Greg Matzik and Jessica Tai with you as the bulk of the Brewers now taking batting practice. Pitcher's still out on the warning track as we get set for opening day. And Bob Uecker is going to be behind the mic for the first pitch of today's game. Now 90 years old. You can't even imagine a Brewers baseball season without Bob Uecker. Some of his greatest calls over the course of time, we have pieced them together for you.
And the pitch to Pauly is lined to center. Get down, ball. Lynn coming on. He can't get it. The ball got by him. All the way to the wall. It could be an inside-the-park home run. Jackson, the pickup. The throw. Monitor coming on. He is in standing. And it is 4-2 on an inside-the-park home run by Paul Monitor.
So, Aaron, we'll see where we are with time.
Cooper's head to right, a base hit. Here is Reggie turning second, trying for third. Moore's going to have a play on him. The throw in time to get Jackson. Oh, what a throw by Moore. Oh, what a throw by Charlie Moore. He was right on line to Molitor, and Molly was waiting for Jackson when he got there. It's over! The Brewers have won! The American League cut it! Milwaukee, you have a World Series!
The pitch, a swing and a fly ball, right field and deep. Get up and get out of here. Gone for Swaim, and they've done it again. 12 in a row on a two-run blast by Swaim to win it. Oh, my goodness. Holy cow, do you believe it?
Back in against Mesa, who is working from the windup. The 0-1 pitch. Swings, and there it is.
so many incredible calls over the years with Bob Uecker. He'll be again behind the mic as the Brewers begin the season at home against the Minnesota Twins. Now joining us from the dugout, Brewers principal owner Mark Attanasio. I know you got to hear some of those highlights, Mark. I don't know if they give you goosebumps like they do me, but it's always great to hear Bob anytime, any day, especially opening day.
Well, and especially in those calls. Yeah, you never get tired of that. Nice to see you. Well, this is a new hookup here with the video, huh?
Yeah, you like that? Yeah, right. Our program's now stream live, so when you're on the show, you're really on the show. People get to see what you're wearing and everything.
Mark, you have been to...
That.
Yeah.
you've had so many opening days, but how are you feeling today despite Mother Nature and the wind and the rain? How are you feeling about today? What's unique about this opening day for you?
Well, everyone is different. It's certainly nice to come in with a sweep. I think we last did that in 2018. I think we had one opening day with snow. It's not quite snowing, but on the way here, which is part of my opening day routine, I called Commissioner Selig, who, by the way, is listening, and said to let you all know that between him and the person driving him, Charles, that there's at least two people listening to us here, so that we got that.
Great.
And I said to him, God bless America, God bless you, Commissioner Selig, and God bless our roof.
So, yes, roof for the wind, we've been saying.
It's always a little different. It gives me a chance to reflect. I reflect on my dad. I'm wearing my, he used to sing opening day for 10 seasons, so it's a good chance to reflect on all the good memories with him. And when I hear these great home run calls that Uke made, it's great to reflect on all the success, especially now we're in year 20. This is season 20 for me and our family, and a lot of great memories.
Well, I'm sure, Mark, as you reflect on 20 years, a big portion of your interest in the team had to do with a brand-new stadium, right? This infusion of youth into the roster at the time, a team that was playoff-starved, that ultimately achieved those goals and has been incredibly efficient in chalking up wins over the years. But you think back to that time, 20 years ago, when you bought the team and became principal owner, can you even begin to document in your mind all the things that have evolved and changed over the years?
No, and you touched on the two. I'm an optimistic person, which I think now that I've been here this long, folks in the community recognize. And I focused on this marvelous facility when I first came here on August 13th, 2004. Well, I'd been to Milwaukee before because my sister-in-law is from here, Lee Stein. Stein Home and Garden Centers, I think they call it. Give them a little plug. But
Stein,
walking in right field, I looked up and I said, I can't believe I could actually own this. And I found out, of course, I couldn't, because even if we bought the club, the stadium district controlled 70% of it or something like that. But that and looking at in those, we had the number two farm system then, Prince Fielder, Ricky Weeks, Corey Hart, and Brian Braun actually wasn't, when I was looking at the team, he was our, Doug Melvin picked him in 2005. So yeah, Greg, you've hit on the key things that we were looking at. And probably too much to go through. I think the seven playoff appearances, I was in the Dominican Republic for opening our facility, and you saw 1981, 1982. And then you saw the seven that we've had. So I think I'm very proud of that many playoff appearances in 19 seasons. And we just missed, in a couple of seasons, we just missed by one or two games. So I'm proud of that. I'm proud of the facilities, starting with American Family Field now and the terrific public-private partnership we have, and we know we'll be here for decades, generation. And then, building out Maryvale to state-of-the-art in Phoenix for spring training. American Family Field's of Phoenix, we call it, by the way, to recommend our sponsor. I should say they've been a big part of everything here. And in Dominican Republic, we have one of the top facilities there now. We own a minor league club in North Carolina. So in terms of the infrastructure of the club, it's great. And if you look at how we've grown, not only the baseball infrastructure, but we now have, I think, 500 employees around the world. That's really something I'm proud of. And you know, is in the Dominican Republic. We have 55 people there, and how proud they are to wear our colors and what, you know, we've done to for their families and what they've done for us. Got a guy playing right field today. If you're wondering what's going on down in the Dominican Republic, take a look at Jackson Churio because he came up through there. And, you know, so, yeah, there's a lot, and we could go on, but that's we run out of time.
Yeah, well, you mentioned the Dominican Republic Academy. I think that's fascinating, and I don't think enough people know about it. Why is that new academy for the Brewers so important as far as developing young talent?
I was talking to the owner of the Marlins this morning. We were talking about how important it is to develop talent, and yeah, that's critical in baseball and in all sports now in development of young talent. And so, you know, if they've got a if you looked at the weight room here, the weight room in Maryvale, and the weight room for, you know, teenagers in the Dominican Republic, there's not that much difference. In fact, it may be larger, given the space constraints here, may be larger in the Dominican Republic than it is here. And having professionals to coach these young people and to educate, you know, we have a classroom that can seat, you know, I think up to 50 students. And it's not only, you know, learning academic subjects, but learning life skills. Because some of these, as we see with Jackson, some of these guys could be here fast. So that's an important part of what we do. And it's important, you know, we've been very focused on where we have our minor league facilities. We control the one in low A. We've got high A in Appleton here. You can get the players back and forth quickly. Double A in Biloxi, and by the way, John Tracy, who owns the Biloxi team, is one of our newest investors and owners at the big club here, and Triple A in Nashville. So we're really well set up from a facility standpoint, and importantly from a personnel standpoint. And I think the organization from back to Doug, when Doug Melvin was the GM, to David Stearns, to Matt Arnold, focuses on promoting internally. So we have folks who get promoted up to the major league coaching level who were in our minor leagues developing players. So it all works together.
It definitely does. Principal owner Mark Atanasio joining us. You talked about Jackson Churio. There's several players who are going to make their, you know, opening day roster for the first time, or have, Mark, and are going to celebrate here today. On the opposite end of that, you know, you've lost all-star talent over the last couple of years. Does that sting you as an owner, or is that just sort of the price of doing business in baseball, that turnover and change is expected and a constant?
I think it stings me on a personal level because Debbie, my wife, and I become close to the families and the kids. And in many cases, we still, like, for example, we still get holiday cards from Lyle Overbay and his family, which has not gotten quite large because his kids have kids. And so on a personal level, it's hard. From a baseball standpoint, I think, I wish we could. The thing that stings is you wish you could keep, you know, the way we were able to keep Christian Yelich, keep players, you know, all the way through their careers. And it's not feasible for, you know, our payroll structure. What happens in baseball is if you have too much payroll concentrated in a small group of players, you know, it's hard to really succeed. We last year, by the way, had, I think, 58 or 59 players come through and play in Milwaukee for at least one game. So, you know, you want as many of those players to, you want a mix of veterans who are, you know, how they're going to perform, and young players with a high ceiling. So you want as many veterans as you can have. And you know, we have limits given the size of our market. But, you know, from 2005, I never wanted to, in fact, first thing I told Rick Schlesinger in those days was, I don't want to hear small market anymore, we're too small. And I just told our investor group, they come to spring training once a year, and they asked about payroll disparity and all that. And look, it's about as wide a disparity as you can have between the Mets and us. And doesn't mean we're going to do better than they are this year, but we did pretty well this weekend. And we can't let payroll get in the way. We just can't think that way. We have to think we're always going to succeed. And everybody here, top to bottom, feels we're always going to succeed. That's one of the, you know, one of the four cornerstones pledges I made in 2005 was to field a perennially competitive team. Now other teams call it sustainably competitive. Well, we've been sustainably competitive since 2005. There's only three teams in the National League that have won more games than we have. You know, the Dodgers, the Braves, and the Cardinals. If you back that up to like the last, you know, 8 or 10 years, it's just the Braves and the Dodgers. And if you look at since whatever, and they slice things this way, but you look since like 2018, the only teams that won 86 games or more every year was the Yankees. I'm sorry, the Dodgers, the Astros, and us. So I think we've so far proven the ability to be sustainably competitive. But you know, every year is a new year, and this year certainly was a challenge trading Corbin Burns. And we'll see how it goes.
Well, we're excited for all the youth on this team. I think that's exciting. And also, as you look up, Mark, and you see this massive new scoreboard and the other new scoreboard too, are you just kind of in awe?
I just, by the way, if you see me looking up for folks actually who are watching and not just listening, I had not seen the scoreboards, and right in front of me is the new scoreboard in right field that's got really terrific statistics. Jackson Churio, I'll mention, we've mentioned him a few times, just came up on the new scoreboard as number 12th in batting in the major leagues. Not bad. Nice. For someone who never, you know, played in the major leagues before it.
Yeah.
And Rhys Hoskins is in the home run leaders. No, he's only got one. That puts very few guys have hit a home run yet. So, I think it's going to – we're trying to make it an event to come to the ballpark and for our fans to have an experience that's differentiated from, you know, listening or watching at home. I mean, by the way, you come to the ballpark and listen to Bob Uecker. He's piped throughout the stadium, so it's not like you can't listen to Uke if you're here. We try to facilitate parking this year. I know it's hard for – I'm in the group of technologically limited people, so I always have a hard time using one of those grids you get on your cell phone to park. But I think we will make it less of a traffic jam in and out now with that. And we're always looking to make the fan experience as good as we can.
Do you have any updates on the parking? Because I know that it's made to be very easy for people with the QR codes. I know you have parking attendants out there to help, but you know, day one, you can always have a couple of issues. What's the latest?
Yeah, I don't have the, and we got some rain today, as we know. So I don't know, as of, we'll find out. Rick Schlesinger's all over that. You know, I think sometimes with these things, you take a step back to take two steps forward. And I know, we were trying to go to we were in New York, and we were trying to go to a play, Debbie and I. And your QR code. Well, guess what? We walk up to the theater, there's no cell service.
Oh.
You can't, you know. So the old kind of paper ticket would have been nice. But in any event, we understand it's difficult. But I think once people get used to it, they'll appreciate it, the ease. It is easier to get in and out of the ballpark. And by the way, you go to some other stadiums, it can take an hour to get out of the stadium, and that's certainly not the case here.
Well, thankful for everything that you've put into the stadium here in this beautiful roof and field that we've got in front of us today. Looking forward to a fun day today and a great season. Brewers principal owner Mark Attanasio joining us from the dugout. We appreciate it, Mark. Enjoy the day today.
It's great to see you here, even though, and Jessica, nice to meet you.
This is, yeah, it's good to
always
see
happy
you,
to
Mark.
Do this.
Yeah, I'm usually in the dugout with you, and we're corralling you and Bob together and all that, but they put me in a lofty perch here, so I get to look at you on a video screen instead.
Yes, the new technology.
You bet.
Great.
Well, all the
thanks,
best, Mark. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
We'll talk to you soon.
Appreciate it. Bye.
You bet. Brewers principal owner Mark Attanasio joining us as our opening day festivities continue here. And it really is. I mean, the ballpark improvements, I think that's something you noticed year after year, whether it's the ribbon boards, the scoreboards, the new food offerings, how they're trying to make it a better experience. And with the rules changes in Major League Baseball that went in play last year, the games are moving along at a quicker pace, and it's made it a more desirable place to go for families. And the Brewers do that better than most stadiums in Major League Baseball.
I think the speed of the game speeding up has definitely helped. And I love that they're staying local with a lot of their new additions. Mm. You talk about, you know, the miniature version of Third Street Market Hall downtown now being here. I mean, it's a destination, not just to get food, but they have games out there too. So that's a spot where you can go. Maybe the kids want to do a little something beforehand.
Sure.
You want to get them inside, get them situated. And it's just going to be, that's going to be a hot spot to go to for sure.
No doubt about that. We've got a few things to get to here before we get to 1 o'clock. Let me first tell you about my friends at the Hounds and Tap in Menomonee Falls. Boy, you talk about a great day to have a mud-free dog park. Today is the day. That's right. The Hounds and Tap in Menomonee Falls. It is a state-of-the-art place for doggy boarding, doggy daycare, grooming services, all right there, professionally done. It is the place to go. Right off Silver Spring in Menominee Falls. Fun, happy, clean. Stop in today. Maybe catch the game. Catch a drink with your dog or without. It's really up to you. Food trucks arriving with more frequency as the weather gets a little bit better. They've got fundraisers and more. Make sure to bring the family with you on Sundays. Check out the Hounds and Tap in Menominee Falls. How can they help you like they've helped us over the years? It's the Hounds and Tap, where every day is a play day.
Serta Pro Painters know how important your home is to you. I know how good a job they do because Serta Pro Painters did our house. WTMJ's John Mercier here. It was professional, it was easy, it was quick, and it was efficient. And so affordable. It's Serta Pro Painters. They get the job done right. Even those hard-to-reach places, they will knock out of the ballpark. Free estimates, reliable communication, professional painting, all at the right price. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters. Choose the team we went with, Serta Pro Painters.
Get help for your house this Saturday from Eric Brown. The president of Siding Unlimited knows his stuff. Yes, their name is Siding, but they do so much more. Windows by Pella and others, roofing, decks. That's why they are Siding Unlimited. Eric can advise you with anything about your home's exterior. Make a point to listen and call Eric this Saturday on WTMJ's Fix It Show. And remember why they are called Siding Unlimited. They are siding and much, much more. See SidingUnlimited.com and you'll see.
The Midwest's best baseball and softball training facility and retail center is here in New Berlin, and it's ready for you and your team. From little leaguers to hardcore players and trainers, this is the place you'll want to be.
You can't beat Burkhart.
Why are people saying "Hugh yeah" to Jackson Hewitt? Find out before it's too late. Hurry into Jackson Hewitt today.
You just can't pass on Les's Glass. Find us at lesglassservice.com.
Hi folks, this is Hank Albert, owner of BBC Lighting. With spring in the air, a young man's fancy turns to ceiling fans. And at BBC, he'll see all the best quality fans and their newest styles. The new fan electronics provide a great method of moving air, and with LED lights, they use less electricity than ever. We have fans in all sizes, from 24 to 96 inches wide, and their motors are warranted for life. At BBC, we advise you on the right fan for your needs, and our prices are the lowest. I guarantee it. We're open Monday through Friday from 9 to 5 and on Saturday 10 to 4 and located at 20th and St. Paul Avenue across from Sobelman's and Bachman Furniture, all near the Pottawatomie Casino. Stay safe and healthy, my friends.
When we're out in your town, come say hi to us as we broadcast live from the Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin mobile studio.
Anytime you hear us when we're out on the road, you can find us live from our brand new mobile studio.
Whether it be Summerfest, EAA, Opening Day, Air and Water Show,
wherever we may be, you can see us on the radio live from the Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin mobile studio.
We are Wisconsin's radio station.
Wisconsin's radio station.
We are Wisconsin's radio station.
We are Wisconsin's radio station.
WTMJ.
Acunet Mortgages and Equal Housing Lender, NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, "no appraisal required." When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, "no appraisal required," and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in 6 provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in 6 on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Right now, the prices of diamonds are probably the lowest we'll see in our lifetime.
Diamond prices are low, low, low. Here's why.
It was hard to meet new people during COVID.
When a person meets their soulmate, they usually get engaged about 39 months later.
People started dating again only about 36 months ago.
Most of the people who got engaged during COVID
or immediately after COVID
were already in a relationship before the COVID lockdown began.
The Wall Street Journal even published a story about all of this.
Low sales of engagement rings created a worldwide oversupply of diamonds.
But now, engagement ring sales are beginning to pick up again.
By the end of next spring, this temporary oversupply will be gone.
And diamond prices will start climbing like crazy.
If you ever wanted to own a big diamond, this is the year to do it.
Find the Kesslers nearest you at KesslersDiamonds.com.
If you want to own a big diamond, the time is now.
Vince Vitrano for Connect Chiropractic. Dr. Alex and his team had my neck, back, and shoulder feeling so much better. One of my fellow patients, Missy, said she actually went in with a slight limp a year ago. That's now gone. I met Tom in the lobby the other day. Said he came in to Connect Chiro after another doc wasn't helping him feel better. Now he's found his home for chiropractic care. You're invited. Open house Wednesday, April 24th, 6 to 8 p.m. at the office in Wauwatosa. Meet the doc, see the place, and learn how chiropractic care can help you. Go Connect Chiro. That's GoConnectChiro.com.
Fleet Farm's got everything you need for everyday life. Brands from Carhartt to Milwaukee to Purina to Goodyear to Rapala to Levi's and a whole lot more. In-store or online, check out all the brands Fleet Farm carries to help make your everyday life better.
Find furniture for life from Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
The crew are finally back in Milwaukee, which means it's time for the real opening day.
Hit deep, deep to left field, backing up Nimmo, turning, watching it sail. Goodbye!
The Brewers' home opener begins against the Twins at American Family Field. Our coverage starts today at 2:35 on your home for the Brewers. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 101, it's 37 degrees and raining. A Fleet Farm storm team alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory has been issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. It's ugly out there, 37 degrees and raining. Expect wind gusts up to 30 miles an hour, and that rain is expected to change into snow. Tonight with that snow, more wind. We have some measurable snow likely, gusts up to 35 miles an hour with a low of 33 degrees. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Julia Fellow. It's home opening day and spring election day. We'll have more on that in just a moment, but first, our nasty weather hitting southeast Wisconsin. Storm Team 4 meteorologist Tyler Moore times out the rain, switching to wet, heavy snow.
Through lunchtime is when we start to see that transition north and west of Milwaukee. That rain-snow line slowly marches down to the southeast. By 4 or 5 p.m., it's starting to push from Port Washington down through Janesville. North and west of there, you're looking at more snow, still rain in Milwaukee. And then once as we hit the evening and overnight hours, that's when the snow comes down a bit more.
Inside American Family Field, it's a bit warmer and drier as the festivities ramp up.
Inside American Family Field, the in-game entertainment crew testing out these little devices that shoot out sparks right by the Brewers' dugout for the pregame lineup announcement. They're running full-screen video on the ballpark's new 12,000-plus square-foot replay board. Fans will be blown away. A couple of guys taking early batting practice, and concessions crews beginning to arrive to serve up stadium fare of all varieties. It's opening day. Vince Vitrano, WTMJ News.
It's a big tradition today for Brewers fans. Kelly's Bleachers shuttle driver Victor Weber has been waiting for this day.
I've been waiting 2 years to do this. I broke my neck last year, so it's a little emotional for me. So just to get back into swing of things, see the people, the camaraderie with all the other shuttle drivers, to just be part of this baseball fanatic action here.
Weber does Wisconsin trivia on his shuttle to keep fans excited all the way to the ballpark. For fans, it's more than just a game. Lindsay Wagner of West Dallas tells WTMJ this is her 20th straight opening day.
It doesn't matter if it's snowing, raining, whatever it might be. No one is going to miss opening day. Everyone loves it. If you're a Brewers fan, you're going to come out in any condition. We love it.
Brewers Network coverage starts at 2:35 right here on WTMJ. It is also the spring nonpartisan primary and presidential preference election day. Polls are open today until 8. A reminder, voters need to bring a photo ID to get their ballots. Another popular way to vote, absentee. Wisconsin's chief elections official reminds voters how to submit their absentee ballots.
Most voters must personally return their own absentee ballot. However, if you need help returning an absentee ballot due to a disability, the law guarantees your right to select someone to deliver it. The person just can't be your employer or a union representative.
Almost 400,000 absentee ballots were requested for this spring election. For first-time voters registering today, you need to have your ID and paperwork. Strong reminder by WTMJ's Jack Grau, continuing our coverage.
And just like that, I have voted for the first time in Wisconsin. Getting into my polling place and then coming out of it took maybe 15 minutes tops. I had to have my temporary Wisconsin identification, proof of residency, but what really saved me a lot of time was having my passport with me as well. The election chief that I talked to was very pleased with the amount of turnout that had been coming in today despite the rain. Polls are open until 8 o'clock tonight in Milwaukee. Jack Grau, WTMJ News.
Time for news about your money in the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Everything in the red. Dow is down 495 at 39,071. NASDAQ is off 188 at 16,208. S&P 500 is down 48 at 5,195. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. Sports, traffic, and weather are next. Setting Unlimited WTMJ News Time 106.
No one wanted to hire me. They just saw my disability, but not me. I worked hard to get the education and the skills needed to thrive. I was ready to work. Then someone believed in me and said yes.
And once you say yes, ThinkAbility Wisconsin will be there, providing transition and workforce support for people with disabilities and their employers to help shape a better future for all. It all starts when you say yes. Join the movement at thinkabilitywi.org.
I know you have a great dog, right? But you know there's room for improvement. At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we can help. Our attention-based training system uses modern technology to help you better communicate with your dog, even in high distraction. When you schedule a free consultation with us, you will have the opportunity to see our training in action and meet for yourself our happy dogs off-leash and under control. Contact Sit Means Sit today at 262-361-3641 or find us on the web at sitmeanssitwaukesha.com to schedule your free consultation so you can have a happy, confident, and obedient dog.
Each day, there's a sliver of time when you can almost breathe freely, and you feel better when you can. But you know that eventually that sliver of time closes, along with your nose. It puts a damper on your day every day. So you pop a pill or you take a spray to try to get that relief back, but it's always short-lived. And all the while in your efforts to give yourself relief, you may be making your nasal breathing problems worse. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula, and a simple in-office procedure from Advent called balloon sinuplasty could be the fast and convenient answer to your breathing triangle problems. Advent has been a leader in this procedure, which can be hard to find elsewhere. It's simple, there's little to no downtime, and it really can be life-changing.
Go to AdventKnows.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Breathe well with simple solutions. Breathe well with simple solutions. AdventKnows.com.
Results may vary.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. It's finally home opening day for the Brewers. The gates open at 1:10 p.m., so just 2 minutes to go. We're live from American Family Field until our Brewers Radio Network coverage starts at 2:35. Bob Uecker will be on the mic for today's home opening game. Let's get a look at the roads with Debbie Lazaga.
All right, Julia. Things are starting to get a little bit more dicey as far as the weather is concerned. So as you're driving in, just be extra careful. Luckily, the accident westbound 94 just west of Highway SS in Waukesha County is gone, so that's been cleared. We do have another one on westbound 94 just past Highway F off on the left shoulder. The other one's still being worked on 894 southbound with the right lane block south of Beloit Road. That's still there and still causing a little bit of a backup. Otherwise, the rest of the area starting to slow down a little bit eastbound on 94 from about 84th Street to about Mitchell Boulevard. And from what I can see, about half of the Molitor lot is full. Can't quite see the Spawn lot anymore. I think that might be already taken out. And we've also got the other ones closer to Hellfair Field starting to fill in as well. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Traffic is sponsored by the Heiser Automotive Group.
Come in and make that deal. Visit Heiser Automotive Group with four convenient locations or online at Heiser.com. Ford, Chevy, Toyota, Lincoln, and Cadillac. Today's your day.
Your Storm Team 4 forecast, a Fleet Farm Storm Team alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory has been issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. And it's ugly out there right now. As we all know, 37 degrees raining. Expect those wind gusts to pick up to 30 miles an hour. And that rain is expected to change into snow. Tonight, windy. More snow. We'll have some measurable snow likely. Gusts pick up to 35 miles an hour with a low of 33 degrees. Wednesday, more measurable snow tomorrow, less south at the lakeshore, but 4 to 6 inches northwest. The high will be 37. Thursday, slight chance of rain and snow showers, more wind, high of 41. Friday, you get to see the sun, high of 43. Same on Saturday, mostly sunny, the high is 46. In Green Bay, it's snowing at 36 degrees. Rain in Waukesha and Milwaukee, where the temperatures are at 37 degrees. I'm Julia Fellow, citing Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 110.
From American Family Field, it's Brewers Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Now, here are your hosts, Brian Noonan and Kristen Bry.
Hello, Wisconsin! We are spanning the state squarely at American Family Field for the Brewers home opener. I am Kristen Bry.
Brian Noonan, and this is very exciting. Happy opening day. Happy home opener for the Brewers. It's we have an. I'm going to be honest. I'm freaking out now. I've been all over Amfib Field. I've been at other ballparks, broadcasting from the Brewers Extra Inning Studio, overlooking home plate and the new Giants scoreboard in center field is the coolest thing ever.
This is a first.
Yes.
I gotta say, I didn't even know this was on my bucket list, but now I'm happy that I can say that I've crossed it off.
I'm never going back to the Avenue.
Exactly. But we are exactly there. We're inside AmFam.
Yes.
We're in the press box. We just saw the line of people very excited to eat.
I'll tell you what. I knew people who worked in sports, and especially sports reporters, love a free meal. I was not disappointed to watch them line up 15 minutes before the kitchen opened, like they were on death row waiting for their last hamburger. It was the whole thing is great. We were going to be in the Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin mobile studio, which has been rewrapped and is outside, right behind home plate. But the weather outside, as we sing in Christmas carols, is frightful.
It certainly is.
It's horrible.
As we saw that little tin box get pelted with rain, I am very happy to be indoors.
Yes.
But we both dressed as if we were going to be outdoors. So it's been a sweaty morning.
It's been a little warm, but now we're inside. And I will say, if you are listening out in the parking lot, good for you. There are some hardy folks tailgating like it was a beautiful spring day out there. The tents are up. I see fires, not because they're rioting, because they're cooking whatever they are, maybe some bear meat that we talked about yesterday. But, were you surprised at how many people are out there with their tents and were out there when we got here about noon?
Absolutely not. Have you not been to a Packers tailgate?
Yes, but snow and freezing cold is different than rain. Like, I can do a tailgate in the cold. Rain is just miserable.
Well, so this is my second home opener in
yes.
life. My first was 2 years ago, and we're actually going to play the feature later in this hour of my first day here, which was no better. Because if you'll remember, 2 years ago, almost the entire tailgate got swept away by the wind. Porta potties were flying everywhere. It was like Kansas and Dorothy.
I'm so happy that for the retractable roof here at American Family Field. I I went on the air the other night and said, I believe any ballpark that is looking for new funding that is in the upper Midwest or the East Coast up there, if you want new funding, you have to put a retractable roof. Because we have, you know, the Brewers' opening day was rained out in New York. Mm-hmm. Put a roof on it. Metropolitans, you know, everywhere. Put a roof on it.
Put a roof on it. All right. Well, our opening day coverage is presented by Pelta Windows. Pelta Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. When we return, we are headed to the dugout with Greg Matzik, where we will talk to Matt Arnold. This is Spanning the State on opening day coverage on WTMJ.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news, our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only. It should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
Hey, boaters!
From fishing to water sports and everyday essentials like anchors and life jackets, along with an incredible selection of hardware, Kendor Marine is a boater's paradise. This is Dave Doro, and our endless selection of boating parts and accessories all but assure you one-stop shopping for all your boating needs. And that's why boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water. Hey, boaters!
This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. And if you're a boater and you haven't been here, ask around. And I think some of your boater buddies will tell you, you're missing out. Because at Kendor Marine, we have everything you need but the water. And when you get here, you'll know. That's no exaggeration. So get in the know, because boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water.
Outdoor living is great, but it's best when it's at your own home. Well, there's a company called Outdoor Living Unlimited that will build you a deck, a patio, pergola, fire pit, all manner of things to enhance outdoor living at your place, even an outdoor kitchen. Get started right away. Contact Outdoor Living Unlimited now. Get your yard project onto Outdoor Living Unlimited's calendar while there's still openings. OutdoorLivingUnlimited.com.
We're starting to see some delays eastbound on 94 as you're making your way in from about 76th Street towards Mitchell Boulevard. From what I can see, it looks like everything is rolling along well right around the stadium interchange, so we're in good shape. Where we are seeing a couple problems, 894 southbound, just south of Beloit Road, right lane is blocked with a crash. That's slowdown stretching all the way back to Oklahoma Avenue. And then we have another one on westbound 94, just west of Highway F. This one is off on the left shoulder, so kind of in a weird spot. Couple of squads with it right now. Very wet roads out there, so things are going to get kind of slick, so you want to be extra careful. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Welcome back to Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I am Kristen Bry.
I am Brian Noonan, and Greg Matzik is down in the dugout with Senior Vice President and Assistant General Manager Matt Arnold. Greg, how is it down field level?
Well, the full GM, Matt Arnold, he's the architect of this team. That's right, of course. Having learned under David Stearns for so many years, he's taken over and taken flight of this team in year number two after organizing a Central Division Championship team last year. And now we're back at it again.
We're back. Exciting. Yeah, it's good to be back, man. Opening day here, can't beat it.
It is amazing to start the season. Now, I always go through this every year with people wondering why the Brewers never start the season at home. It appears, you know, let's get through the first week and then we'll bring the Brewers back home. But nonetheless, you get three wins in New York to start the season. You talk about a great launching pad to today. It couldn't have been better.
That was a lot of fun. Yeah, it was great to see the guys playing hard. You saw the energy that Murph had. All of our players playing with a ton of energy. And, yeah, off to a really good start. It's been a lot of fun.
So, Kristen, Brian, we were talking before coming back on air. We were talking about, you know, state parks and doing trips. Matt actually said a few years back they drove from Arizona. Forget, you know, taking the flight back from spring training. It was kind of a weird time in 2020. They drove back, went through all these different state parks, and made their way back to Milwaukee. He did assure me they did fly back from New York. He did not drive from Milwaukee to New York.
Yeah, that's not a great drive from New York to Milwaukee. Matt, it's been a very interesting offseason. Other than, of course, having to replace Craig Counsell, what was your biggest accomplishment, you think, during this offseason leading up to today?
Man, it's everything on our roster is open, you know, and that's the thing. We want to stay nimble. We want to stay flexible. We want to try to make the team better, you know, and so we had to make some tough decisions, obviously trading somebody like Corbin Burns. But then you bring in somebody like Rhys Hoskins, and we saw what he did early in the season for us, bringing a ton of energy, fighting with the Mets, you know, leading the guys out on the charge. It was awesome. You know, just trying to keep the guys spicy and loose and a good combination. And so yeah, it's always something in our job just to put the best team on the field we possibly can.
I was going to ask that because sometimes, you know, I think we get accused of being a little too Midwest nice. Do you think some of these new guys are going to bring a little more feistiness to the team?
There's no hospitality here with the Brewers. No, we're coming to bring it every day, and that's the thing. You know, that we have a saying on the wall that says "Win today." You know, and that's a big part of what we want to do. And however we're going to do that, we're going to try to find the way to do that. So that's our goal every day.
Yeah, we were talking with a couple players throughout the course of the day here, and I asked Blake Perkins specifically, you know, what's different, a Pat Murphy-led Brewers team versus a Craig Counsell-led Brewers team? And he said, you know what, it's a lot of the same principles, a lot of the same conversations that Pat and Craig used to have. Well, Craig's not here for those conversations now, but the philosophy moves forward. I think we saw that in the first few games, Matt. Felt like anytime somebody was on base, they were on the next base within just a moment's time. Aggressiveness on the base pass, trying to use the full game to win games.
Yeah, exactly, Greg. You know, that was the one thing I think, just having that continuity was so important for us. I mean, as you know, Murph and I have both been together here for 9 years with Craig and David, obviously, who we got to see this weekend. And, you know, it's carrying on that level of continuity that we have, but continuing to build on that and trying to just get better at everything we've done in the game, and Murph is going to lead the charge for us for sure.
So out of new fan experiences, we got a new fancy scoreboard, we got new food from the 3rd Street Market Hall, we got a new parking system. What are you most excited about as far as the fan experience?
Man, it is a ton of fun at this ballpark. I mean, every day, to be honest, the weather's great inside right now, so it's going to be nice.
Yes, it is.
That's the main thing. If you want just a nice place to stay warm, this is going to be the spot. And it's going to be loud in here, too. There's going to be a lot of energy, and I'm really looking forward to it. It's going to be a lot of fun.
First pitch set for 3:10, and, you know, you're seeing a new face on the roster. Kristen and Brian and I were talking about this before. A lot of people making their debut in a Brewers uniform in Milwaukee today. Just thinking back, and I don't have the information in front of me, is this the most new faces you'll have had sort of break with the team and then also kind of have their first opening day experience in Milwaukee?
I think it might be, yeah. I want to say we have somewhere like 11 first opening days for guys. That's a lot, you know, and I think that you generally see some wide-eyed, you know, new faces. I didn't think we saw that, you know, on the line there. I think the guys were ready to go, and I think that's, again, credit to Murph. He kind of turned the dial a little bit more in spring training, especially towards the end, to let guys know, hey, we got to be ready on opening day, and I think he did just that.
Matt, the fans are very excited for Jackson Churio to be starting here today. What was it about him that you saw and said, this is a guy that has to come to the Brewers?
Yeah, that's a great question. Yeah, I would say, just going back to when he was a young kid, you know, we've known him since he was 12 or 13 years old, which is crazy, but he's just such a good athlete. I feel like every time I see him, he grows a couple inches, and he's just a great kid and a great player. And, you know, when you have all your information suggests, hey, this kid is the real deal analytically, and then you have all the veteran baseball people that have been around this guy, whether it's our coaches, our scouts, just all the people around this guy said, hey, he's the real deal. And so we felt like he was the right guy to extend and with the contract that we did.
It is such an interesting contract and a way to do business, Matt, because a lot of times in baseball, you end up paying for what somebody's done at the major league level, and you're hoping to get, you know, the best and maybe a couple more years of that high caliber of play. With Jackson, it's more about paying for what you think he's going to be. Is that a challenging situation to be in?
Absolutely. Yeah, you're betting on a lot of unknowns there, and certainly you're betting on a person, you know, and those are, you never know exactly what you're going to get. But again, we felt like there were all the ingredients that he has, the way he plays the game, how hard he plays the game. You saw a couple of infield hits that he beat out, the plays he made in the outfield, you know, hitting doubles, you know, just like doing all these things in the game. And just a kid that just turned 20 years old, we're really excited to have him.
All right, Matt Arnold, Brewers Senior Vice President and General Manager, thank you so much and good luck.
Thanks,
today.
Matt.
We're so excited to be here.
Have a great season.
Appreciate you guys. You too. Thank you guys very much.
All right, Greg, we'll catch you in the dugout later this show. This is Spanning the State on WTMJ Opening Day Live. We'll be right back.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about AccuNet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us, and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this. Who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated? Might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Here's to sweet summer days together with friends and family in Wisconsin. To discovering magic in every moment.
Come on, over here.
And to reconnecting through a world filled with wonder.
Wow.
Here's to supper club celebrations and dancing until the sun goes down. Here's to those who Wisconsin. Plan your summer getaway at travelwisconsin.com.
Welcome back to Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I am Kristen Bry.
I'm Brian Noonan. We are in the Brewers Extra Inning Studios for our Opening Day Live broadcast. We were brought in from the elements, which is nice. I'm hoping that I know there's a lot of talk about this new parking system. The app is overwhelmed at this point, so people are having a lot of time. It's still not opening for people to get in.
It's still not opening?
No. The nice security guard as I came in the Pottawatomie Gate was like, yeah, nobody's able to open it, so this is what I'm telling people to do. So if you're coming in, be patient. You have 30 minutes after the game starts before you start getting tickets.
You're still buffering?
Oh, yeah, it's been buffering and buffering. So just be patient. Don't forget you have to scan the code and do that. It's supposed to work great.
I'm sure it will work great.
It will work great. Technology is terrific till it's not.
Well, and also new things.
New things.
Sometimes you need patience with new things.
No, patience. Yeah, I like just handing a guy a 20 and driving it in and park it. It's really cool. But it'll work. It's just if you're coming today, just have patience, like Kristen said. Unfortunately, she's partnered with somebody who doesn't have patience today. So that is that. But this is very exciting. And again, The people who are tailgating, I think, are probably some of the sturdiest folks. They are the same ones that you talked about going to the Packers tailgates. And I'm sure at the Badger tailgates and all over.
The elements.
The element. You got to be
on the elements.
Makes you
a true Wisconsinite.
Right.
To tailgate in the weather, in the elements.
Of course.
With the beer blanket.
I still don't know what a beer blanket is.
It's when you, at least I think this is, it's when you drink a certain level that you think that you're warm.
Oh, okay. Well, that makes sense. Then I'm sure I've had a beer blanket on many times. I just didn't know the term. I thought it was problem drinking, but that's just me. So this is not your first opening day. It's my first opening day at AmFam Field. I have been to opening day before at another ballpark. I went to Sox opening day, which was very cool. So we have something after the news. We are going to hear from you because you... On your first opening day, you were not just here as a fan.
Yeah, so 2 years ago, I was on the morning show with Eric and Vince, and it was my first ever opening day because I grew up in Madison, and so it was not a tradition in our family to play hooky from school and come down and go to the game, and then I left Wisconsin for a long time. And so when I came back, I was working for WTMJ, and I said, let's go record some advice that people gave me as far as what you have to do on opening day. And so when we come back from our local headlines, we're gonna revisit that feature because I think the advice still stands.
I need that advice.
All right, so when we come back, my first opening day experience, some great advice, but local headlines are next.
Citing unlimited WTMJ news time, 1:30 on the dot. Voters will make choices in everything from the presidential primary to their local school board. There are also two constitutional amendments that deal with the outside money in elections in the state, as well as nearly 100 tax increase questions for local schools. Polls in Wisconsin are open, and they close at 8 p.m. tonight. The national political scene coming to Wisconsin today as well. Former President Donald Trump will make an appearance at the Hyatt Regency in Green Bay this afternoon. Meanwhile, the White House says President Biden will visit Madison on Monday, April 8th. The president will also visit Chicago that day. Just south of Milwaukee, eight candidates are hoping to make their way into the Kenosha Unified School District. The three highest performing candidates will get three-year terms. The candidate with the fourth most votes will serve a two-year term. Kenosha Unified faces hard times as last year they voted to close schools, repurpose buildings, and cut staff. They are the third largest school district in Wisconsin. Additionally, Kenosha residents will elect their third mayor in over 30 years. Time for news about your money in the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. The Dow is down 471 at 39,095. NASDAQ is off at 184, 16,211. And S&P 500 is also down 46 at 5,197. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite, financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. Let's get a look at your roads with Debbie Lazaga.
All right. Things are starting to heat up a little bit right around the stadium as far as folks getting in at Mitchell Boulevard, for example. So just watch out. A little bit of a backup from about 84th Street to Mitchell Boulevard. Southbound 894, where we had that earlier problem with Beloit Road, that actually has been cleared. Still have some delays around that neck of the woods, so careful with that. And then on northbound 4394, a couple of disabled vehicles and a couple of incidents right around the Holt Howard Avenue area. So if you're seeing delays through there, that's pretty much what is going on there. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Your Storm Team 4 5-day forecast. A reminder, a Fleet Farm Storm Team alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory has been issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. It's not good out there. Pretty ugly. 37 degrees, raining, wind gusts up to 30 miles an hour. And that rain is expected to change into snow. Tonight, windy. More snow. We'll have measurable snow likely. Gusts pick up to 35 miles an hour with a low of 33 degrees. More measurable snow tomorrow. Less south and at the lakeshore, but 4 to 6 inches northwest. The high will be 37 degrees. Thursday, slight chance of rain and snow showers. Windy again, high of 41. Friday, we get to see the sun. High of 43. Saturday, mostly sunny too. High of 46. In Green Bay, it's 35 degrees right now and snowing. It's 38 degrees and raining in Milwaukee. I'm Julia Fellow. Citing Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 1:33.
Welcome back to Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I am Kristen Bride.
I'm Brian Noonan. It is good to be here. Brewers taking on the Twins this afternoon. Coverage starts at 2:35 right here on WTMJ. Should be a good game. Brewers riding high after a three-game sweep of the Mets. So
very exciting.
Very exciting. They're probably very excited not to be playing out in the elements here on the beautiful field.
You wouldn't even know.
You wouldn't know. And I got to tell you, this new scoreboard that everybody is talking about that right now says opening day, it's like something out of 2000, what was the George Orwell book?
1984,
2004, whatever. It's a monolith. It's great.
It's truly beautiful. And it was not here when I was here 2 years ago.
No.
So I told you that 2 years ago was my first opening day, and I was very excited to come and get people's advice on what to do on any opening day, but especially your first one. So I thought we would revisit that because
okay.
It is indeed evergreen.
As a newbie, what is your advice for me today?
Enjoy the tailgating, enjoy the beverages, basically enjoy the atmosphere and everything that Miller Park has to bring.
And Fan Fields?
And Fan, oh goodness. Yes.
Well, you have to have a brat. And I hope that you've already accomplished the fact of walking around the lot and smelling all of what it is to be here at Ann Fan.
What advice do you have for someone on their first opening day ever?
You always have to pick someone on the sausage races. You have to. Why is that important on opening day instead of like any Brewers game? It's a thing. I don't know. Why not? Who did you bet on? Always the Italian. Always. How did that work out for you? Don't ask. It's not a winning record. I'm sorry. Do you have any advice for what to do on opening day?
Drink lots of water.
Fair. Anything?
Drink lots of beer.
Okay, another one. You need a 50-50 raffle ticket, or two, or seven.
Have you ever won the raffle?
No, but the odds are in my favor.
Oh, you got to get something out of a helmet. So you got to get ice cream or nachos or whatever there could be in the helmet, and you get to keep that helmet. And the rule is, once you finish it, you got to wear the helmet, nachos or whatever it is on top of your head.
That's a rule?
As far as I know, legally binding, I think it is. Part of your ticket, I'm pretty sure there's like small print that says, after finishing nachos, put the helmet on your head.
First opening day, what advice do you have for a noob like me?
Just try all the food. Just get out there. I currently have a delicious brat in hand with stadium sauce, which is barbecue and ketchup combined.
Isn't that supposed to be a secret?
It isn't anymore.
Once you're in the stadium, what is your go-to food?
Beer.
The sixth food group that none of us, you know, we always forget about that.
Yes, absolutely. That frozen margaritas, for sure.
What's your favorite opening day memory?
We were tailgating what we call turtle burgers. So it's hot dogs, a burger patty, sausage, all mixed in one. And then the gentleman that was cooking them slipped in a grease fire and it exploded.
Wait, this is your favorite memory?
Yeah, it was great. It's hilarious.
Coming when it was like 80 degrees on opening day and they had the roof open was getting sunburned to high heaven was an amazing day.
Would you rather be sunburned or windburned?
I'd rather be here, whatever it takes to get here.
What's your favorite part of opening day?
The smells.
Just smells.
Peanuts. Just fresh grass. All the smells.
All right, you guys.
I think at this point, after COVID, it's just being around people and being able to have a good time.
Go Brewers.
Go Brewers.
Gene Miller here. Springtime, better start thinking about those home improvement projects. Now's the time to call my friends at Hometown Windows and Doors. Update your home's curb appeal and build equity with energy-efficient replacement windows and doors from brands like Pella, Anderson, Marvin, and more. Hometown can also customize your project. They're your local source for wood, vinyl, or fiberglass windows and doors. Stop into their newly remodeled showroom in New Berlin to see the Hometown difference. That's Hometown with an E for your every window and door need. HometownWindows.com.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. Whether you're ready to work in the yard, tackle a project, or enjoy family time, we get you the right products at the right prices. Right now, rewards members get a free $10 Blaine's gift card with a $100 purchase of Estate Fertilizer, 8 packs of Duracell AA or AAA batteries, $7.99. $50 off select Whirlpool water softeners, and get a free $20 Blaine's gift card with a PetSafe Stay and Play wireless fence. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Don't let a cold, sinus infection, or allergies ruin your day. Breathe easier, sleep better, and feel healthier with Navage. Visit Navage.com, Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, or a store near you.
Hey, boaters!
Now, I wasn't eavesdropping. I just happened to overhear him talking about us. He said if you know what you're looking for, just rummage around. You'll find it. And it's true, because we stock more boat parts and accessories than anyone. Even those oddball parts you thought you'd never find. This is Dave Doro, and boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We've got everything you need but the water. Hey, boaters!
Truly the best supplier around for all of our boating needs. This place is magic. I call it my candy store for boating parts. This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. And yeah, I said it, but these are the actual words of our satisfied and loyal customers. Boaters in the know exactly where to go, and there's a reason. We've got it all for our boater buddies. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news! Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
Fleet Farm's got everything you need for everyday life. Brands from Carhartt to Milwaukee to Purina to Goodyear to Rapala to Levi's and a whole lot more. In-store or online, check out all the brands Fleet Farm carries to help make your everyday life better.
Visit family-owned Ken Michaels Furniture and our in-store design centers where you'll still find beautiful, luxurious, heirloom-quality American-made furniture. Right now, save 30 to 35% store-wide and take advantage of our complimentary design services. Whether you're moving, renovating, or updating, our designers will help your vision become a reality. Visit Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield on Capitol Drive and in Greenfield on Highway 100 to save 30 to 35% store-wide today. Sleep better and save more with mattresses from Milwaukee Mattress and Ken Michaels Furniture. Handcrafted in our Milwaukee factory, our mattresses utilize natural materials like cotton cushioning, which dissipates body heat, Joma wool quilts for warm wintry nights and cool summer evenings, and natural latex providing superior conformability and pressure relief for aching joints. Stop in today at any Ken Michaels Furniture store and save up to 50% compared to national brands.
We got eastbound on 94 kind of backing up, heading in towards the stadium interchange from 92nd Street. So that's something to keep in mind. We do have a new accident, though, on 94 westbound at Highway SS. We got the left lane block. Looks like a car went headlong into the median wall. That is going to be affecting your ride for sure. We got squads and officers walking along around that area, so you want to be extra careful. Give them a wide berth if you can. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Live Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin on WTMJ. I am Kristen Bry.
I'm Brian Noonan. We are lucky, Kristen, because they moved us from the Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin mobile studio because of the inclement weather. So we are inside nice and cozy, and yet Eric Bilstead, who has paid his dues for years, he still has to be outside in the rain. I'm feigning empathy for him, but I'm glad he's out there because he's been talking to all kinds of people. It's probably clearing up out there, right, Eric?
Boy, I don't know who I upset, but I upset somebody. No, it is absolutely. I fully admit, Ryan and Kristen, that I am a wuss. I fully admit that, but this is absolutely miserable.
Like, is it?
I'm amazed. And I'm impressed too. I'm in awe of the tailgaters that are just cranking away, that are grilling, that are doing it. They have the tents up. They're dealing with the wind. They're dealing with the rain. Lots of folks dealing without an umbrellas that are walking into the stadium right now. And oh my God, they are going to be wet the entire game.
How many people do you think are, for the people who are already in the parked, but who's still tailgating? Like, can you give a rough estimate of what you're seeing right now?
God. Tons. Like, if I just scan, if I scan the parking lots, there's all kinds of tents. You know what I mean? Like, all those canopies are up. There are tons of canopies. Yeah. And not only that, by the way, it's windy. So, you know, the weights need to be put on those to keep them from going anywhere. I haven't seen any of them blow away yet. I wanted to tell you, so among the sea of fans wearing blue and gold, I did see one guy wearing a Philadelphia Phillies jersey. And I'm like, what? Who wears a Phillies jersey? But here's the most amazing part. You're going to see this guy on TV, I guarantee it. He's wearing a Rhys Hoskins Phillies jersey. Rhys Hoskins is now the very popular first baseman of your Milwaukee Brewers, right? And he's from Philly. He lives in Oak Creek now. And he told me, he's like, you guys are going to love this dude. He's got the Philly grit. And he brought a sign that says, making Mets cry since 2017.
So, love it.
So he will be on television today at some point, I guarantee it.
That's excellent. Has anybody taken pity on you and brought you into their tent to let you get out of the elements?
Yeah. Yes, actually, a couple of people let me in and offered me some food. I turned them down. I had a Minnesota Twins fan offer me to sit in his car with them before they pulled into the parking lot. And I was
That sounds sketchy. Yeah, not a good idea.
Thanks for being nice, Justin Morneau fan, but no, I'm not getting in your vehicle. So, yeah.
Yeah, those Minnesota nice people are—they worry me, quite frankly.
Right.
So, what have people been saying? You're coming in?
No, go ahead.
The people that you're talking to, who as they're still tailgating, they just unbothered, unflappable.
The one guy said, "Hey, we've been through snow, we've been through wind, we've been through all kinds of stuff before. We've been to Packers games, so why wouldn't we be here?" And I said, "Okay, I get that. I respect it. However, man, like, here's the thing. I don't know if every fan is realizing." They're making the long walk, some of them without umbrellas, into the stadium. They will get soaked. I mean, it is pouring.
Yeah.
It is pouring out here. My umbrella I'm going to toss because it's all shredded up from the wind. But it's awful. But, hey, if people are enjoying it, everyone seems to have a smile on their face. I love it. More power to them.
I'm not going to expect you to cry for me, Eric. I had to walk from my car, and, oh, it was miserable. Now, not so much.
I mean, but Brian dropped me off at the gate, so I really got the princess treatment.
And you're drinking hot cocoa now. It must be nice.
And we're getting foot massages. I've never been in the press box. It's unbelievable up here.
All right,
Eric, well, stay warm, and we can't wait to hear some of the interviews you got.
Thanks,
all right,
Eric.
Happy opening day.
Eric Bilstead, upsetting upper management, so they sent him out in the rain. I don't know why, but he's doing a yeoman's job out there.
And another guy that we got on the other side, still in the elements, in the rain, Adam Roberts. Where are you tuning in from?
Hello, Kristen. Hello, Brian. I got to figure out what Eric did to upset people because I must have done the same thing.
You guys need to.
About in the right field area of Bam-Bam, and it is an absolute smoker. I heard that ad for Kendor Marine in the last spot. Everything you need but the water, well, we got plenty of it. A flowing river past this canopy city that I'm set up with. And thankfully, much like our friend Eric, I was taken in by a wonderful group of Brewers fans. No Twins jerseys, no Phillies jerseys to be found here. A healthy mixture. We've got everything we need. We've got some heating setups. We've got the food. We've got the drinks. We've got Shutbox. One of the guys set up a Shutbox, four-way Shutbox kit with the garbage can as a pseudo table. So very crafty and very creative, even amongst the elements today.
Well, have you talked to anyone about the parking situation? Because I know Brian said his is still buffering.
Yeah, so I have been talking with people throughout the afternoon as they've been working their way. We've been talking about throughout the day there are the parking scan QR signs around the lot. And I've gotten a pretty healthy mix, guys. On the one hand, people who have said that they've been having the spinning wheel when they try to scan things. And so the attendants kind of said, yeah, park here. We'll come around with our hand scanners later to get you on your way. And then the other half have said it's completely seamless and they've had no issues. And compared to opening days of the past, where you had, of course, the long lines of cars even up until so Stitchwell, I can report that I'm standing right by near Wright Field where you come from the general lot off 175, and it is a ghost town on the road. Absolutely no line to speak of.
All right. Well, Adam
Thanks,
Roberts.
Adam. Stay
we
dry.
We will tune back in with you.
This is exciting. We're sitting in this man's chair right now. Dom Catronio, who hosts Brewers Extra Inning. He hosts Brewers Weekly. He's dressed like a working journalist today. He's here. Thank you for letting us come in and use your studio.
I mean, you guys, as long as you guys leave it cleaner than Greg and Jessica did, I think we're going to be okay.
Yeah,
but
they're sloppy, let's be honest.
But no, it's my Spanning the State debut, so
Absolutely.
Thanks for having
Welcome
me.
Welcome to the show.
Absolutely.
It's
exciting
great to
day.
Have you. Yeah, it's a home opener. You know, coming off that three-game sweep in New York, what are fans now who are all excited? They're like, oh, 3-0, we're going to the World Series. Not to temper their enthusiasm, because we love that enthusiasm, but what can they expect to see not only today, but as this new team starts to move forward?
So let me follow that up with a question to you. What's your favorite era of baseball, Brian? You remember that old school, right?
Like that, 70s, yeah.
Like that, you know, I'm thinking of Ozzie Smith,
Pete
Cardinals,
Rose,
Pete
Ozzie
Rose, play
Smith,
Charlie Hustle, right?
Ricky Henderson, those kind of guys.
That's a perfect name, because that's the kind of baseball you're going to see. The mix of speed and power, the mix of stolen bases and the home run, the most exciting plays in baseball. Everybody loves the home run, but also stolen bases are pretty sweet, too. That's what this team has a beautiful blend of. They're already 8-for-8 in stolen bases. It's the most they've ever had in the first three games of a year. They haven't been caught yet. They've got dynamic players like Jackson Churio, obviously. The wunderkind, he's 20 years old. Doesn't look like it in the box. Then you've got Yelich, obviously, who had a great opening weekend. You've got this great mix of what the fans want. On top of all, that's still one of the best pitching staffs in baseball. Yeah. So that's the brand that I'm so excited to watch, is this team that's fast, athletic, stay on your toes, and also play amazing defense all season long.
What's the biggest change that you've seen under Pat Murphy as opposed to the end of last year?
I almost said something I shouldn't say, but and with all due respect
Hold
to Craig
on.
Counsel, you know, the vibe is different in a good way, if you get what I'm saying. Look, I have so much respect for Craig Counsel and what he's done in his career, and quite frankly, sometimes that seriousness and this kind of stoic, nothing, you know, gets past me kind of thing, it gets old after a while. And I'm not saying Pat Murphy's going to love us all season long. He loves us right now. But, you know, I joked with him, hey, in June, I'm going to remember that the fact that you like talking to the media. Like, hey, when you're on a little four-game skid or something, and I ask you, hey, what about bringing in this guy? And he's like, why'd you ask me that? That's going to happen. But I think the biggest difference, this team's taking after its manager in a good way. And again, I'm not trying to slide on Craig Counsell or anything like that. Pat Murphy is intense, but he knows how to turn it down, and he knows how to be funny. He's one of the most sarcastic people I've ever been around. He's one of the funniest people I've ever been around. I've known Murph since I was in college, because we both Arizona State guys. Yeah. And it's really fun to see him be the same guy, even though the title is different. And Christian Yelich talked about that today, actually, too, is the fact that, you know, obviously the rest of the coaching staff is the same, and Murph is this constant, funny, but also, when he wants you to get something right, he's going to pull you, get it right. Okay. And there's a command of excellence, and there's a command of, I expect you to be a big leaguer. I think Pat Murphy's a great blend of that.
Very cool. All right, what can fans expect for the pitching matchup today?
This is a different one, right? This is a weird one. You got Louis Varland over on the other side against Jacob Junis. Jacob Junis making his Brewers debut, came over from the Giants organization this last year as a free agent. Junis has a great breaking ball. There's a lot of lefties in that lineup, though, that can neutralize that breaking ball. I see this being a day that maybe Junis goes 4 or 5 innings and then hand it over to the bullpen, given the fact he had an off day yesterday. You have another off day on Thursday. You could be a little more aggressive with your bullpen, given how great it is and what a strength it is for the Brewers. But as far as the Brewers and their attack on Louis Varland, I see a guy with a heavy fastball, and be ready to hit on that fastball.
All right. I must compliment you on your sartorial presence, mostly
the
your shoes.
Yes.
The Brewers
saddle shoes?
Yeah, so these are some Allen Edmonds, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so a friend of the program, Bill Schroeder, of course. This is his 30th season over on television with the Brewers this year, former Brewer, of course. And one of the gifts he gave me a few years ago working with him in 2021 was he gave us all a pair of Allen Edmonds custom Brewers embroidered. You know, they're pretty great. And it's funny.
You keep them clean, too.
I need to wear them more, probably, is why. But I walked into the clubhouse today, and Devin Williams and Bryce Wilson look at me and look and like, dude, really? Like, because normally I'm wearing Jordans. I'm wearing, you know, some fresh Nikes
or something like that.
And that's exactly what I said. Look, I can only wear these twice a year, opening day in the playoffs. So hopefully you see them again.
Did you wear those outside?
Oh, yeah. I know. I had an umbrella and everything. Hey, it's quality leather.
Allen Edmonds are top of the line.
Presidents.
Top of the line.
Come on. But yes.
Very nice.
Tomorrow I'll be back to my normal uniform of Lululemon pants and a polo or something like that. So we'll be back to normal.
We caught you today. That is excellent. Thanks for coming by.
Thank you, Brian.
Have a great season. People can hear you after the game in your studio where we're sitting. We'll clean up and make sure everything is back to normal on Brewers Extra Innings. You'll get Brewers Weekly, covering the Brewers, everything Brewers.
Yeah, exactly. Try to be your guy. You can follow me on Twitter at Dom_Catronio. It's the really Italian one. You can find it eventually. But thank you, guys. Thanks for having me. Happy opening day.
Thanks, Dom. Happy opening day.
All right. We'll be back after this.
Throughout history, some people have been born into greatness because of their name or family. Others gained greatness because of their actions. On Wisconsin's Morning News, we celebrate everyday heroes, the John or Jane Doe, who had no idea when they woke up one morning they'd be saving a life. Everyday Heroes, Thursday at 6:40 on Wisconsin's Morning News, presented by Azura Memory Care and Assisted Living, transforming the culture of care.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about AccuNet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several $1,000s over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Outdoor living is great, but it's best when it's at your own home. Well, there's a company called Outdoor Living Unlimited that will build you a deck, a patio, pergola, fire pit, all manner of things to enhance outdoor living at your place, even an outdoor kitchen. Get started right away. Contact Outdoor Living Unlimited now. Get your yard project onto Outdoor Living Unlimited's calendar while there's still openings. OutdoorLivingUnlimited.com.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us, and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this: who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated, might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, Siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
This is Matt Meitner, owner of Sit Means Sit Dog Training. Do you find yourself talking to your dog but feel like she's not listening to you?
Bella, sit!
Are you constantly repeating yourself but she's not following your directions?
Sit! Sit!
Frustrating, isn't it? At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we want to help you have a happy, confident, and obedient dog, and we also want to make the training process an enjoyable and worthwhile experience. Contact Sit Means Sit today to schedule a free consultation so we can create a customized training program so you are able to have the dog you want and deserve.
Sit Means Sit Dog Training.
Sorry, we don't train husbands, wives, or kids.
Need to hire quality candidates fast? You need Indeed. Their video interview tool makes it easy and effortless to meet with candidates. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
Are you tired of being tired? Go to AdventKnows.com.
There's a reason people sold to Grandview Homes instead of using a real estate agent.
Very fair price. No real estate agent fees or closing costs.
Within weeks, we had closed and couldn't be happier.
Visit GrandviewHomes.com to discover the easiest and fastest way to sell a home.
I'm Brett Machke, and you're due for service. Richlands.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station. The crew are finally back in Milwaukee, which means it's time for the real opening day.
Hit deep, deep to left field, backing up Nimmo, turning, watching it sail. Goodbye!
The Brewers' home opener begins against the Twins at American Family Field. Our coverage starts today at 2:35 on your home for the Brewers. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 1:59, it's 38 degrees. A Fleet Farm storm team alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory has been issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. Right now, it's a wet mess. 37 degrees and raining. Expect wind gusts up to 30 miles an hour. That rain is expected to change into snow. Tonight, windy and snow. We'll have some measurable snow likely. Gusts pick up to 35 miles an hour with a low of 33 degrees. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Julia Fellow. Your top story at this time is opening day, and the rain changed some fans' plans.
Many early arriving fans skipped the tailgate altogether. Nathan Downauer and family were first in line at the home plate entrance waiting for the gates to open.
I'd rather stand under here in the cover than sit out in the parking lot in the cold rain.
Yep. We've had some clunkers for opening day, but this isn't good.
No, this isn't good. Last couple of years have been great, but this year's not the year for it.
At American Family Field, Vince Vitrano, WTMJ News.
It's also becoming a new tradition for some fans. Matthew Hickson grew up in Florida and tells WTMJ today is his first Brewers game.
The fact that all these people are here under these weather conditions means a lot. So rain, hail, sleet, or snow, Brewer fans will always be out here. So I'm just glad to be here.
Hickson said he's excited to join all the crowds. It's not just Brewers fans picking AmFam this afternoon.
Among the sea of fans wearing blue and yellow at American Family Field is one guy in a Philadelphia Phillies jersey, a Rhys Hoskins Philadelphia Phillies jersey. The Brewers first baseman used to play for Philadelphia. Jim from Oak Creek tells me,
I think he's kind of grew a thick skin because you had to. So I think he brings that grit with him to Milwaukee, and I think you guys are going to enjoy it.
Jim is a Philly native. He brought a sign along with him that reads, "Making Mets cry since 2017. Outside American Family Field, Eric Bill said, WTMJ News.
It's also spring election day. Wisconsin's chief elections official reminds voters about polling times for election day.
Polls are open until 8 p.m. across the state. And voters who are in line by that time still have the right to cast their ballot.
Voters still need to bring a valid photo ID to get their ballot.
Your ID should be unexpired, or in the case of some, like a Wisconsin driver license, it can still be used if it expired after November 8th of 2022.
Today's ballots include nonpartisan races as well as presidential preference.
Having a state-issued ID is critical for voting today, and that process starts at the DMV.
I'm at the Milwaukee Central DMV location off of Chase Avenue on the south side of Milwaukee, and the longest part of getting a temporary Wisconsin license that I can take to my polling location was waiting in line to get up to the desk. Now that I've got my temporary license as a former Illinois resident, I can head to my polling location to get registered to vote. All told, I was at the DMV for about an hour. Jack Grau, WTMJ News.
The DMV extended hours until 6 p.m. today for everyone to be able to get their IDs. Time for news about your money in the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Everything in the red. The Dow is off 442 at 39,124. NASDAQ is down 198 at 16,198. And S&P 500 is down 47 at 5,196. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. Sports, traffic, and weather are next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 2:03.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news! Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
Hey, boaters!
Truly the best supplier around for all of our boating needs. This place is magic. I call it my candy store for boating parts. This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. And yeah, I said it, but these are the actual words of our satisfied and loyal customers. Boaters in the know exactly where to go, and there's a reason. We've got it all for our boater buddies. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We've got everything you need but the water. Hey, boaters!
Now, I wasn't eavesdropping. I just happened to overhear him talking about us. He said if you know what you're looking for, just rummage around. You'll find it. And it's true, because we stock more boat parts and accessories than anyone. Even those oddball parts you thought you'd never find. This is Dave Doro, and boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Injuries happen, but you don't have to play in pain or stay on the sidelines. Whether it's your kids dealing with a sports injury, college athletes, or the rest of us weekend warriors, the experts at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin will quickly diagnose your problem, lay out a treatment plan that works for you, and get you back in the game. They fixed my knee. My mother-in-law is back on the dance floor with a new hip. These are the experts you can trust. Visit orthowisconsin.com.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. It's finally home opening day for the Brewers. We're live from American Family Field until our Brewers Radio Network coverage starts exactly a half hour from now, 2:35. Bob Uecker will be on the mic for today's home opener. Let's get you to the game with Debbie Lazaga.
All right. Well, we got a problem. Holly Road. We've got an accident on 94 eastbound right at Holly Roads off on the right shoulder. A little bit of a bottleneck coming out of the Zoo interchange to that point. We've also got an accident on 94 westbound at Highway SS. The left lane is blocked. With that it was a car that went into the median wall there. Otherwise, other pockets of heavy traffic through the construction zone on 894 westbound to Forest Home. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Painting Time Saver Traffic.
Your Storm Team 4 5-day forecast. We want to give you an alert. Fleet Farm Storm Team Alert. A winter storm warning has been issued for Fond du Lac County. A winter weather advisory has been issued for Sheboygan, Dodge, Jefferson, and Washington counties. Not great out there. 37 degrees and raining. Expect wind gusts up to 30 miles an hour. Rain expected to turn into snow. Tonight, windy, more snow, measurable likely. Gusts pick up to 35 miles an hour with a low of 33. Tomorrow, more measurable snow. Less south and at the lakeshore, but we can go up to 6 inches northwest. The high will be 37 degrees. Thursday, a slight chance of rain and snow showers. Lots of wind, high of 41. Friday, we get the sun back. High of 43. Same for Saturday. Mostly sunny. High of 46. In Green Bay, it's snowing right now at 35. Rain in Waukesha at 36 degrees. And the same in Milwaukee. I'm Julia Fellow. Citing Unlimited WTMJ News Time 207.
From American Family Field, it's Brewers Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Now, here are your hosts, Brian Noonan and Kristen Bry.
Welcome back.
Oh, my goodness, it's exciting.
How are you feeling? You got a hot dog in that
drink. I had a hot dog. I went to the press dining room. There is still a line, like it's like they're giving the food away, which they are. They're giving it away, so everybody's lined up in there. But the hot dogs are like for the, I don't know, the common folk, so I just went over and got a hot dog. I didn't stand in line. It wasn't an option. It's almost, the hot dogs have been decimated, so there's only a few left. If you want one, I'll cover. You run, get yourself a hot dog, because it's like a radio station. When they leave food out, it's gone immediately.
Well, there you go.
But the Brewers put on a nice spread in there.
So nice spread.
I like that. We have a parking update that we want to tell people about, because if you're coming in, we've talked a lot about the new system where you're scanning a QR code and that's the way you're paying for your parking. But this from the Brewers, some people are experiencing issues with trying to activate their parking today, myself included. The Brewers recommend periodically attempting to connect, but in the meantime, parking ambassadors are going to be roaming around, and they have handheld scanners to assist the fans. So if you're coming in now and you're having any trouble with the QR code and getting into the app, look for one of those parking ambassadors. You can't miss them. They're all dressed in yellow because they're going to their second job as Gorton Fisherman after the game. They're all in their slickers, and they will help you with their handheld scanners.
There you go. All right. Well, all eyes are on Pat Murphy today, and this morning, Wisconsin's Morning News got a chance to talk to the guy in charge.
I didn't come in here to participate and say, oh, the old man got a chance to manage.
For the first time this season, we're joined on this opening day by Brewers manager Pat Murphy. Morning, Skipper.
Good morning, guys.
Listen, we haven't done this before, but let me tell you, it's going to be the best part of your week for the next 6-8 months, I promise.
I'm certain it will be a good part of it, I'm sure.
Hey, I wanted to ask you that because we played that hilarious clip of you addressing the team at the front end of spring training, saying, look, this isn't about me getting a chance to manage. You know, certainly at this point in your career, you got nothing left to prove. I wonder, was there a moment where you thought, do I really need to do this?
I was pretty much wanted to do it.
Nice.
You know, there's times during your career when you're like, really, you know, what's next? And whenever you start looking ahead, you miss the potholes that you're walking right past, you know, and it's so true. So I just kept my head down and things worked out. I had some great opportunities and this one worked out and I couldn't be more pleased. I've told Mark a million times, Mark, this isn't work. You know, this is a life work. If work needs to be included in the phrase, this is a life work. It's something I love. Matt Arnold and his staff have been great. You know, I have a great staff around me, guys that I'm familiar with. So this has been a fun thing. We've got an uphill battle and, we got to figure some things out, but we're heading in the right direction.
So, Skip, is it a challenge to connect with that young generation?
You mean my old ass? Is that what you're saying?
I thought he phrased it very nicely. I don't know.
Is it hard for your old ass to relate to the younger crowd?
Yes.
I don't know. Probably. I don't know. I just do what I can do, man. I'm just myself. I don't try to relate. I just, you know, I'm authentic, I think, most of the time. I like to keep it light. And at the same time, I like to try to achieve things people don't think we can.
This being opening day, Skipper, where does it rank in terms of in the opening days that you've had at any level? You've been around baseball a long time. You've seen a lot of them. They're all special in their own way. How does this one set up for you today?
Oh, there's no question that you know, I'm excited to come to work every day, whether it's first game or fifth game. And I don't want to de-emphasize anything about opening day, that's for sure. But I'm excited the same every day, and this isn't about me, so it doesn't matter how I'm feeling. It doesn't matter if, you know, it's a great thing for me or not. It doesn't matter. You know, this is about players and getting them to play right. That's my job, and I can't get out of that mode. I can't get all, you know, for all the happy horse crap. I can't get all excited about that. I got to stay in my mode.
So Pat, we've been talking.
Makes for a bad interview, but sorry. You guys signed up for it, not me.
So we've been trying to figure out. So on opening day or the home opener, there's always, they introduce everyone. Everyone out, runs out to the first base line and tips their cap and gets an applause. So we've been trying to figure out who's going to get the loudest ovation this year. And some of the candidates, Reese Hoskins is who I expect would probably get a pretty loud reception today. Brandon Woodruff is a dark horse candidate that someone had suggested. Someone else suggested that you will get the loudest ovation. Who do you think on the club is going to get the most praise?
Let's see where this is on my list of importance today. this is a great question. Wow, what a great question. I can't find it on my list, but Jackson Churio.
Yeah. Hey, listen, on that, I wanted to ask you about this. So watching the game Sunday afternoon out there in New York, and Churio goes 2-for-4 on that day. That infield ground ball that he legged out, Pat, was sometimes a guy gets to base because the shortstop is ranging far to his right and has to throw off balance. And things. That looked like a borderline routine ground ball that your guy legged out. He's crazy fast.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know that it was routine. He hit over the top of it. It wasn't a great swing. It wasn't a great at bat. But we'll take the good fortune, because sometimes you hit a line drive and it gets caught. But that wasn't a great at bat. They get credited for a hit, but not in my mind. But he is tremendously fast. And, you'll see a lot of that out of him if he hits over the top of the ball. But then it'll dwindle, because if he keeps hitting over the top like that, it'll be taken out of the lineup. So. Get comfortable with it now, because he might not be in there if he keeps doing that.
Brewers manager Pat Murphy on Brewers 360. Really look forward to talking to you through the season.
Yes, sir. Happy opening day.
Thanks.
All right, sir. We'll see you out at the yard 7:52 on Wisconsin's Morning News.
Acunet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit verified pre-approval the same day, and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
You know what happens when a smart group of medical professionals get together and commit to a technology designed to relieve your aching joints without surgery? It's called QC Kinetics.
And this guy knows the power of a solid team. Emmett Smith, football legend and Dancing with the Stars champ.
This elite medical group, some of them orthopedic doctors, got together and said, why are we prescribing so many medications? Why are we sending so many people to surgery in droves? Let's change this.
The answer, natural biologics, our own healing properties. And the outcome is the country's largest provider of non-surgical regenerative treatments, QC Kinetics.
Actually, the real outcome are the tens of thousands of patients who finally got their quality of life back without surgery. Thanks to QC Kinetics.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Dan, what'd you do this time?
What do you mean?
10% off all closet designs?
I think everyone should have an inspired closet.
That's what I'm saying. So, 10% off. Or they can choose 18 months free financing.
Inspired Closet customers can choose what works best for them.
With our free consultations using our 3D design software, now is the time to calm your closet chaos.
Promotion ends soon. Visit us at InspiredClosetsMilwaukee.com.
A wife and husband team.
If you're like me, you always like to add a little something new to the wardrobe. But when money's tight, it makes it harder. And that's why you shop at St. Vincent de Paul for a terrific selection of women's clothing at thrift store prices. Brand names, too. With a selection that's always up to date and looking great, you're going to find something cute at the right price, and you're going to love it. St. Vincent de Paul thrift stores on Highway 100 in Layton and Greenfield and 23rd in Lincoln in Milwaukee.
Ooh, you're going to love it, St. Vincent de Paul.
Hey, John Mercier here for Floor Coverings International. They just did the flooring in our house, and it is stunning. Carpet, luxury vinyl plank, in and out quickly. They rolled up with that mobile flooring showroom. Incredible. Came in, walked us through everything. The installation was quick and easy, and it is absolutely gorgeous. FCI, the stars of flooring. Each Floor Covering International business is independently owned and operated. They are the real deal. Go to FCIfloors.com for a free consultation. They'll transform your home. FCIfloors.com.
What's the difference between a flag and a bath towel? Both are made of material, but one is also invested with deep meaning. The material and the meaning go together. Dr. Michael Ziegler says that also describes the connection between earth and heaven. Learn how the followers of Christ are raising God's flag in the world. Hear Dr. Ziegler's message based on the book of Acts this week on The Lutheran Hour.
The Lutheran Hour, Sunday mornings at 6:30 on WTMJ.
Well, backups are pretty much out there no matter where you go because of the wet roads. We've got a few accidents to deal with. We've got one on 94 eastbound at Hawley Road off on the right shoulder, just about ready to be cleared. Still, though, heavy from the zoo all the way to the stadium. We've also got an accident on 94 northbound. The ramp from or just past Layton Avenue, the left lane is blocked with this as you head through into the Mitchell Interchange. Have a few incidents going on. The Holt Avenue on-ramp to northbound 4394 closed right now because of an incident. And on 94 northbound, just north of 7 Mile Road, we've got cars on either shoulder with another crash there. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Welcome back to Opening Day Live, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I am Kristen Bry.
I'm Brian Noonan. This is a very exciting game time, less than an hour away. First pitch, and boy, the stands are starting to fill in. People are getting crazy. We're seeing things on the Jumbotron. Everybody's having fun. If you are still arriving at the ballpark, the Brewers have asked us to let you know a little something about the new parking system. From the Brewers, some people are experiencing issues trying to activate their parking today. We recommend periodically attempting to connect, but in the meantime, parking ambassadors will be going through each lot with handheld scanners to assist fans. So if you're just getting that circle that just keeps spinning and spinning and spinning, look for one of the parking ambassadors and they will help you. One of the men on the one of the best rotations in baseball, Colin Ray, is in the dugout with our own Greg Matzek. Greg, it's getting close. This is very exciting.
Yes, it is. You know, Colin and I were just talking about what you do on an off day, and the short answer is running, a lot of running and trying to get ready for his next start. But, Colin, you're on the list of players, I think it's 12, that get an opening day experience for the first time at American Family Field. And I don't know, there's something to that. Even though you've been with this team for going on a year, first opening day at American Family Field's got to be special.
Yeah, it is. It's definitely a little specialer for me just being this close to home. You know, I came to this ballpark a little bit growing up, and but yeah, always a special moment to just be on the team and be a part of this moment.
And then you come back with three straight wins, right? I know it's early, but winning is always better than the alternative. And to start your season the way you guys were able to start, and you're a big part of that too, that's got to add a little more juice to coming back and playing in front of a home crowd with a 3-0 record.
Definitely, I think we played very well in New York, and you know, we were just aggressive, we competed, you know, and that's kind of our motto, like, go out there, compete, you know, no matter the situation, be in the moment, be present, you know, worry about tomorrow when that comes, and that's kind of what we did in New York, and it got us off to a good start.
So, Kristen and Brian, we're just playing back part of Pat Murphy's interview with our morning show from earlier today, and one thing that we can tell from Pat is that he'll always keep us in the media on our toes.
Yeah.
I assume it's the same in the clubhouse, right? I know you've been around, Pat, for going on a year, but what's it like being part of a Pat Murphy-managed team?
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely going to keep it light, keep it fun, but, you know, there's, you know, there's no BS there. Like, he's going to want you to go out and play hard, and you know, he does a good job of sending the message in spring training, you know, relaying that what I said earlier about just being present, being in the moment, coming to the ballpark to win today and worry about tomorrow when we get there. And, you know, it's a lot of fun. I've known Murph for a long time, so, and I actually had him as a manager in San Diego when I got called up. But to still be with him and with the Brewers, it's going to be a fun year.
Hey, Kristen, it's a lot like what we do. The more we make fun of each other, the more we like each other. I feel like it's
just
that
like
way
siblings,
the Brewers,
right?
Too,
it's
right?
Just it builds trust.
There you go. Hey, Colin, everybody in baseball says the Brewers have one of the best rotations. What is it about the mix of guys on this rotation that makes it so strong?
Well, I think there's a lot of things, but I think the biggest thing is just we're coming every day to the ballpark and we're paying attention to the little details, you know, just a little bit, even how we play catch that day, you know, not taking any throws off, being super focused when you're in the bullpen and working with Hookie and Jim, just between mechanics and, you know, pitch types and where our hand is at and our delivery at release point. So I think it's just getting those little things, the fundamentals down every single day. I think, you know, we're not taking a day off. So I think we got a good staff that kind of comes in and does that every day.
I have to ask, you had two stints in Japan. I know the game is the same, but what, for American fans, what would we be surprised about if we were at opening day for the Fukuoka SoftBank Hawks?
Well, it's different in the sense where the fans, they're cheering nonstop from pitch one to the final pitch. They don't take a breath. I mean, it's just like nonstop. The environment's really, really cool. Excuse me, but you know, as far as the baseball part, it's pretty much the same. They play a little bit more small ball over there, I would say.
Okay.
You know, they're going to be bunting in the first inning and try and, you know, put up as many runs as they can, any way they can. But, you know, the baseball part's pretty much the same. I would just say, you know, the fans are just insane over there, and they pack it full every night.
Very nice. Post game meal's a little bit different too, right?
Yeah, post game meal's a little bit different. A lot of ramen and stuff
sake.
Like that. But
that sounds delicious.
Sake, yeah,
she sounds delicious.
Yeah.
Well, Colin, thank you. Have a great season. Happy opening day, Greg. As always, thank you for your help down in the dugout. And you know, I know you'll be talking about this all tomorrow too. So happy opening day.
You got it. Appreciate it, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, so we're almost done.
We're almost done.
This is.
I need to go have a hot dog now.
Yeah, see, I wanted to avoid the rush. But plus, I get hangry. You know that about me. It's fun seeing all the people coming in to the stadium. AmFam Field looking fantastic. When you get in here, the new scoreboard is awesome.
That's really impressive.
It's twice the size that it was last year. Now the one over right field is almost as big as the center field was last year. It's all ultra LED. It's beautiful. If I wish I could just watch this as my TV all the time. But we want to thank everybody back at the studio who's been helping. Aaron and Aria, we're doing all that
for
us.
Great day.
And our man John Tyler here, and keeping his eye on us and not letting it. Of course, Vince and Eric and Aaron,
and Adam,
and they're all out there in the rain.
They can probably come in soon.
No, let's keep them out there.
Yeah. Keep them out there.
Yeah, keep them out there. That's really if they've done something that bad, they need to learn their lesson. All right. Well, listen, it's opening day. First pitch coming your way after 3 o'clock. We've got to say goodbye.
But we'll be back. Actually, we'll be back on Thursday. Because we have Brewers baseball tomorrow.
Yes.
But it has been fun. I'm going to go have that hot dog and a beer because we're not on air anymore.
That's right.
Happy opening day, everyone. We'll see you on Thursday.
Brewers baseball is next.
Hey, this is WTMJ's Steve Scafidi. I talk a lot about politics, but sometimes I just want to sit back and have a nice conversation about, well, whatever I want to. This week on the Scafidiology podcast, regular contributor Martin Moore on the TikTok question.
The parents invented all this stuff, and the parents are using this stuff right in front of their kids. So I'm surprised adults are surprised that kids use this stuff as much as they do, because this is all they know.
You can listen to this conversation or any of my Scafidiology conversations wherever you get your podcast or at WTMJ.com.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us, and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this: who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated, might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated, because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news! Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly